Joe Mathis.
Listen to us on your smart speaker. Just ask to play our call letters. WHIR.
The IRS, the world's most aggressive collection agency. They can seize your property, bank account, and garnish your wages. They cause sleepless nights for millions of Americans. Don't be one of them. If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state, get protected today. Call 800-312-9970. Coast One Tax Group, protecting your bank, home, and your sleep since 2008. With hundreds of five-star reviews and an A-plus on the Better Business Bureau. Call Coast One Tax Group, 800-312-9970. Stanley from New York owed $93,000. The IRS placed a levy on his bank account. Coast One released the levy and settled with the IRS for $2,000. Mark in Michigan owed $225,000. After Coast One stepped in, Mark walked away paying less than $1,500. Call Coast One now. A 10-minute call can save you up to 93% on your back taxes. Get your fresh start today. That's 800-312-9970.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by...
Thank you there, Jackie Boy. Brought to you by Dexter and Reitmeyer Insurance, your local independent insurance agency. Proudly representing the Auto Owners Insurance Company. Ask if auto owners make sense for you. Call Mark or Chris, and they'll give you a free quote, 236-6686. Partly sunny skies, a high today 58, a low tonight of 39. Sunshine tomorrow, 70s the high. Thursday, showers light. Likely mostly cloudy, a high of 67, rain showers Thursday night into early Friday morning. Right now it's 6:11 in the morning, it's 52 degrees in Danville, Tuesday, October 17th. It's Joe Show time. Let's rock and let's roll.
Say, look at JoJo.
Good morning to you, Danville and Boyle County. It's time for the Joe Show on 103.9 FM WHIR. All right, folks, Tuesday, October the 17th, and today we celebrate National Pasta Day on the Joe Show. Linguine, fettuccine, spaghetti, tortellini, ziti. The list of pasta is endless. It's typically thought of as an Italian dish, but there is evidence that people living in Asia all the way back in 2000 BC made noodles with millet. Pasta can be made dry or fresh. There are over 350 varieties of dried pasta in Italy. The highest quality of dried pasta is made with pure durum semolina flour and water. Did you know that a typical Italian person eats over 60 pounds of pasta per year? Today, National Pasta Day. It's also Wear Something Gaudy Day. Halloween isn't for a few weeks, but thankfully, all of you folks that are eager to dress up can do so a little early this year. Wear Something Gaudy Day. Dig deep into your closet and find your craziest outfit. Today, Wear Something Gaudy Day and National Pasta Day on this Tuesday, October the 17th edition of The Joe Show. Phone number to call in this morning, 238-WHIR. That's 238-9447. We start you off, as we always do, with the playing of our national anthem. It's brought to you by Bob Allen Motor Mall and the Hometown Radio Network.
The Bob Allen Motor Mall and Hometown Radio Network proudly honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Bob Allen Motor Mall Hometown Radio Network, teaming up every morning to honor America with a playing of our national anthem. Phone number to call in this morning, 238-9447. That's 238-WHIR. We'd love to have you this morning here on the radio, on the Joe Show, as we do a little birthday party action this morning here on the Joe Show, WHIR. Not a long list of birthdays, but a list nonetheless. Here's how our list looks this morning. Scott Elder celebrates a birthday today. Scott Elder having a birthday. So is Marcus Bagwell, Bernard Montgomery, and Sharon Martin on our birthday list. 238-9447 is the phone number to call in this morning. 238-WHIR. We'd love to have you right here on the radio on the Joe Show. 238-WHIR, the phone number to call in. It's a Tuesday. It's October the 17th. Typical Tuesday morning show we have lined up for you. And it starts off this morning at 7:10, about 55 minutes from now. Boyle County head football coach Justin Haddix will join us. We'll talk Rebel football. Boyle County is hosting Wayne County this week. Wayne County and Boyle County in a game we'll have on our sister station, Z105. We'll talk with Coach Haddix about that Wayne County defense today. That'll be at 7:10. 7:20, Danville head football coach Frank Parks Jr. joins us. The Admirals are taking on Breathitt County. Finally a home game for Danville after having to travel to Leslie County 2 weeks ago. And Somerset last week. We'll have that game this Friday right here on WHIR. Coach Parks talks with us every Monday through Friday at 7:20. 7:40, it's the County Agents Corner, brought to you by Bluegrass South Livestock Market. And this morning we have Jessica Besson who calls in from the Mercer County Extension Office. That'll be at 7:40 this morning. In the 8 o'clock hour, 8:10, we have Colleen from the Boyle County Public Library. 8:20, Randy Graham has Ramblyisms, the thoughts of Randy Graham and Randy Graham's thoughts. Tuesdays and Thursdays at 8:20. 8:40, James the Gardener joins us. We have Gardening with James, and look forward to talking with James this morning. And in the 9 o'clock hour, 9:10, it's Dusty with the Kentucky Music Preview. 9:35, it's either Ann Yeager or Mary Stiff Hamlin with Stiff Funeral Home, and Tuesdays with Stiff. That's the rundown of today's show. We'd love to have you on. Phone number to call in this morning on the Joe Show is, again, 238-WHIR. We start you off this morning, as we always do, taking a look at early morning sports. And here it is. The Phillies take a 1-0 series lead over the Diamondbacks. The Rangers, a commanding 2-0 lead. And the Cowboys win on Monday Night Football. Those are the headlines on this Tuesday morning. I'm Joe Mathis, guiding you through these Tuesday morning sports. Starting off in NLCS Game 1 last night, where can they build a statue of Bryce Harper now? Is it too early to retire his number? Harper is celebrating his 31st year on Earth through his raucous birthday party Monday night in front of 45,396 of his closest friends at Citizen Bank Park, igniting a show that reverberated throughout the city. The Phillies blew out the candles in the Diamondbacks in Game 1, 5-3, with Harper smacking a home run in his first at-bat and added a hitting a run-scoring single in the third, with his buddies chipping in two home runs themselves. The Phillies dominated the game from start to finish, with Kyle Schwarber leading off the game with a 420-foot homer, and two batters later, Harper homered on his first pitch, sending Citizens Bank Ballpark into a frenzy that never stopped. In the ALCS, the Texas Rangers are playing practically perfect baseball right now, and even when they err, they have a knack to pick up each other, and perhaps that's the biggest gulf between them and the Houston Astros right now. The Rangers move within two victories of the World Series and remain perfect in this remarkable postseason run by beating the Astros 5-4 last night. Thanks to another yet postseason masterclass from Nathan Eovaldi, the Rangers took a 2-0 lead in the ALCS and improved to 7-0 this postseason with six wins in the road, and will head to Arlington home, needing two wins in three games to reach their first fall classic since 2011. Last night in football, the Dallas Cowboys didn't win in San Francisco the week before, but they got a big victory in Los Angeles last night. The Cowboys hung on to defeat the LA Chargers 20-17 on Monday night. Dallas kicked a 39-yard field goal with 2:19 left in the fourth quarter, and then the defense intercepted Justin Herbert on the Chargers' final drive to preserve the win. Cowboys quarterback Dak Prescott had a bounce-back game. Prescott completed 21 of 30 passes for one touchdown and had a rushing score. Wide receiver CeeDee Lamb produced 7 11 catches for 117 yards. Cowboys star defender Micah Parsons had 2 tackles, 1 sack, and 3 quarterback hits in the win. And staying in the National Football League, L.A. Rams starting defensive back Darion Kendrick was arrested Monday morning, hours after the Rams won over the Cardinals on felony gun possession. The 23-year-old Kendrick was pulled over for a traffic violation early Monday, and police found a gun in the vehicle. He was booked at 2:14 in the morning for the felony charge of carrying a concealed weapon. Rams coach Sean McVay confirmed Kendrick's arrest Monday and said the team is, quote, continuing to gather more information. Those are the headlines on this Tuesday morning. I'm Joe Mathis for the Hometown Radio Network.
Did you know that WHIR AM 1230 is the talk of the town? We're not spreading gossip. We're just letting you know where the best talk radio is found all day, every day. Mornings begin with Danville's own Joe Mathis and The Joe Show.
Hey, this is Joe Mathis.
Wake up to what you missed. News, weather, sports, and local guests. Followed by Kentucky Sports Radio with Matt Jones.
Welcome, everyone. Kentucky Sports Radio. I'm Matt Jones.
Then, the man who has an opinion about everything, Tomas Mauricio.
I'm Tomas Mauricio. I invite you to tune in.
Starting at noon with Advocates for America.
Then at 3,
it's the best-known name in news, Sean Hannity.
Join me, Sean Hannity, on WHIR.
Then, Joe Pag starts off weekday evenings at 6 with his take on the day's news, mixed with his fun parody songs about the news.
Hey, it's Joe Pag on WHIR.
Afterwards, at 10, it's the unique world of John B. Wells on WHIR with his Caravan to Midnight show.
This is John B. Wells, WHIR, AM 1230 and FM 103.9.
These guys have a lot to say, and they'll be glad to have you join them every weekday on your home for news, talk, sports. AM 1230, WHIR, the talk of the town.
Sutton Pharmacy, friendly service from people you know.
Generations of serving our community, immunizations, prescriptions, and so much more. Helpful people, free local delivery, mobile app refills right to your door.
Visit SuttonRx.com. Sutton Pharmacy. Friendly service from people you know.
In Lancaster on Maple Avenue.
Be cautious of repair people who stop by unexpectedly. If they demand cash before they perform services like roofing or painting, it could be a scam. Hi, I'm Adam Hopkins, security officer at Farmers National Bank. Ask for references and don't be pressured to pay before the work is done.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by...
Thank you there, Jackie Boy, brought to you by the Big Deals Online Store. Go to hometownlive.net, shop and save on gift certificates to local businesses at big-time discounts. Save up to 50% every single day. Big Deals Online Store, hometownlive.net. Partly sunny, high of 58, low tonight 39. Tomorrow, sunshine, high of 70, low of 51. Thursday, rain showers likely, about a quarter of an inch of rain possible. Maybe even more Thursday. And then Thursday night, it really comes down. Right now, it's 623, 52 degrees here in Danville. Tuesday, October 17th. 238-WHIR is the phone number to call in. We are looking at celebrities having birthdays today on this October 17th. Starting off with 51-year-old Marshall Mathers turns 51. We know Marshall Mathers better as his initials, Eminem, 51 years old today for the rapper Eminem. Not Afraid, Lose Yourself, amongst some of his biggest hits. Here's a clip of Eminem talking about how he's written everything that he performs. He writes and he raps. Everything he raps, he has written. Here it is.
Regardless of what any of these other dudes do, I have never, not even a line, not even anything. I wouldn't be able to have fun with it if I couldn't write it.
51 years old today for Eminem. Other birthdays that we have today, Norm Macdonald would have been 64 years old. Late comedian, born on this date 1959, died 2 years ago back in 2021. Late daredevil Evel Knievel would have been 85 years old today, born on this date 1938. He died back in 2007. And astronaut Mae Carol Jemison is 67 years old today. She was the first African-American woman to journey into space. She also also appeared on Star Trek The Next Generation back in 1993. May Carol Jimison, 67 years old today. Birthdays and anniversaries all day long on The Joe Show.
On this day. In country music.
Well, that's nice of you there, Mr. Voice. It was on this day, country music history. Looking back at the year 1941 in Portsmouth, Ohio, Earl Thomas Conley was born. Country music singer and songwriter. In the 1980s and 90s, Conley charted more than 30 singles on Billboard's Hot Country Songs charts. It was on this day, 1958, one of the all-time greats was born in Noonan, Georgia. His name, Alan Jackson, country music singer who's recorded over a dozen studio albums. Alan Jackson having a birthday today. He is 65 years old, and it was on this day, country music history, in the year 1999, Tommy Durden died at the age of 79. He was a very well-known American steel guitar player who played on some of the great country songs of all time. And that's what's gone on this date, October the 17th, in country music history. Starting off in 1941 in Portsmouth, Ohio, where we celebrate the birthday today of what would have been Earl Thomas Conley's birthday. And apparently I hit the wrong button because now it's playing an ad before this song plays. Here we go. Well, I guess I forgot to hit pause on the video, so it kept on playing through when I got the video loaded up, or the song loaded up, I should say. So here it is, Earl Thomas Conley.
Heart isn't blind. It just sees what it wants.
Conley's 18 number one country singles during the 1980s decade marked the most number one hits by any artist in any genre that decade. So he was a guy who was the most popular in the 1980s. Conley's music has been referred to as thinking man's country because the narrator looks into the heart and soul of his characters in each one of his songs. He died in April of 2019. Earl Thomas Conley would have been 82 years old today.
Nobody falls like a fool. Nobody loves like a believer.
Yeah, it was on this date, 1958. Noonan, Georgia is the place. Alan Jackson was the person, country music singer, who is considered one of the all-time greats, particularly in that decade in the 90s and 2000s.
Well, way down yonder on a Chattahoochee, it gets hotter than a hoochie-coochie. We lay down.
How about 35 number one hits for Alan Jackson? 2 Grammys, 16 CMAs, 17 ACMs. And a member of the Grand Ole Opry. Alan Jackson, on this date, 1958, was born. Happy birthday to Alan Jackson.
Yeah,
65 years old today. And it was on this day, 1999, we mentioned Tommy Durden died at the age of 79, most notable for writing and co-writing and playing on this song.
Well, since my baby left me, well, I found a new place to dwell. Well, it's down at the end of Lone Street.
How about Heartbreak Hotel by Elvis? He later performed as a steel guitarist for Tex Ritter, Johnny Cash, and Johnny Tillotson. Tommy Durden died at the age of 79 on this day, 1999.
You still can find some room for broken-hearted lovers to cry there in the gloom. Be so, make us so lonely, baby.
Tommy Durden, Alan Jackson, Earl Thomas Conley have all made their mark on this date, October 17th, in country music history.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cartown Kia.
It's your choice. The new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cartown Kia and CartownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 due at sign, 2023 Kia Sorento, 2556 due at sign, go $349 down, $349 per month, 36-month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, dock, and acquisition fees with approved credit. No security deposit required. All incentives to dealer price may not include dealer added options. See dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Northern Kentucky University, the host of last night's gubernatorial debate. Incumbent Democratic Governor Andy Beshear and Republican challenger Daniel Cameron, the current Kentucky Secretary of State, using the time to verbally spar a bit as the election nears. One of the discussion points, the UAW strike and the effect of Louisville's Ford Kentucky truck plant walking out. The challenger, Cameron.
Wages need to be increased. These workers know that, but they are having to deal with the challenge of more expensive groceries, more expensive gas, and more expensive childcare. What I think is incredibly important is that you have a governor that eliminates the income tax to make sure that these folks have more money in their pocket to pay for those things that I just talked about, and also, again, increase their wages at the plant. I support the workers and will make sure that they have leadership in the governor's office that works for them.
And Governor Beshear's response.
What we have to have here is a win-win. Our UAW families are fighting for better wages and better health care benefits, something we should want for every single one of our citizens. We need them to come out of this, being able to provide more opportunity for their kids, a better future here in Kentucky. But we also need a strong Ford coming out of it. They invested $5.8 billion in our Commonwealth. We're building the two biggest battery plants on planet Earth.
Audio courtesy WCPO-TV. King of Kentucky Bourbon is returning for its sixth annual release. Brown-Forman announcing the limited edition expression is a 16-year-old Kentucky straight bourbon. Only 3,800 bottles will be available at a price of $300 each. I'm Sean McCormick.
This is the Kentucky News.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cardtown Kia.
It's your choice, the new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cardtown Kia and CardtownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 due at signing, 2023 Kia Sorento, 2556 due at signing, $349 down, $349 per month, 36 month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, dock, and acquisition fees with approved credit. No security deposit required. All incentives to dealer price may not include dealer added options. See dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st, 2023.
When two flavors collide, the result is something magnificent. Co-starring chocolate alongside peanut butter. The Peanut Butter Crunch McFlurry. Vanilla soft serve with crispy cereal mix and chocolatey peanut butter cookie pieces. Critics are giving this 5 stars.
I'm a critic and I give this 5 stars.
See? Told you. And I'm using a movie trailer voice, so you know it tastes good. The Peanut Butter Crunch McFlurry. Rated T for tasty at McDonald's of Danville and Harrodsburg.
Planning a wedding? Paying for a wedding? Attending a wedding? Hi, this is Pim Fister-Clark with Wedding Planning with Pim, inviting you to join us Monday through Friday after the 8:30 morning news on WHIR AM 1230. I'll give you sound wedding planning advice and money-saving tips, information you need. And you'll get it all right here at your favorite radio station, WHIR AM 1230.
Lawson's Tractor 2, your local Kubota equipment dealer, wants to help you deliver a job done right. That's why they want you to know that the new Kubota inventory is arriving daily. You have work to do. They have the reliability and durability and versatile lineup to help you do it all. Visit Lawson's Tractor 2 today for all your equipment needs. Lawson's Tractor 2, 4 miles south of Danville on Highway 127, open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, and Saturday, 8 to noon. Lawson's Tractor 2.
This is a Hometown Radio Network information update. Ephraim McDowell Health is now helping fight food insecurity with the Ephraim McDowell Food Assistance Partnership Program. The program provides individual boxes of non-perishable food for food insecure patients and their families upon discharge from any of Ephraim's 3 hospitals, Ephraim McDowell Regional Medical Center in Danville, Fort Logan Hospital in Stanford, and Hagen Hospital in Harrodsburg. The food boxes include shelf-stable meal items that are easy to cook and is intended to feed a patient and their family for up to 2 days. Families can participate in the Food Assistance Partnership based on their responses to a survey they take when they're admitted to the hospital. It's Frank X. Walker Creative Arts Festival Week at the Danville School System this week. The event started yesterday and continued today with a Frank X. Walker Artist Talk for the middle and high school students. Tomorrow with the Frank X. Walker Readings at Hogsett and Tolliver. And then Thursday and Friday with the Creative Art Workshops in the schools. There will also be an opening reception and a Frank X. Walker Visual Art Exhibit beginning today and going through October 28th. Frank X. Walker is a Danville High School graduate who was appointed Poet Laureate of Kentucky in 2013, the first African-American to hold that position. And two school resource officers will have their own SRO vehicles thanks to a donation to Lincoln County Schools. The Ohio County Sheriff's Office recently donated two used police cars to Lincoln County Schools and the Stanford Police Department. Lincoln Schools says the vehicles will be used for their school resource officers. The first phase of repairs to the Anderson Dean Park pool have been approved. The Harrisburg Herald reports that at their last park board meeting, the board of directors approved a $175,400 bid from American Leak Detection of Mount Washington for phase one of those pool repairs. The Anderson Dean Park pool had been closed since June after officials learned the pool had leaked 1 million gallons of water in its first week it was open. And remember, today is the pop-up driver's licensing program in Lincoln County. Last year, the state changed where you get your licenses and renew them by making regional driver's license offices. However, it's still inconvenient for some to get to those other counties. So to make it easier, they're hosting pop-up programs. In our area, Lincoln County will host a pop-up driver's license program today at the Lincoln County Public Library. Meanwhile, Mercer County will have theirs on Thursday at the Mercer County Courthouse. You can register online at the Kentucky Transportation Cab website, drive.ky.gov. I'm Joe Mathis.
Need a change of scenery? Check out Kentucky State Parks. With 45 parks to choose from, there are limitless options. Each park has its own unique features, landscape and resorts, restaurants, campgrounds, and some of the best golf courses around. Pick one that fits your lifestyle and your family. Explore Kentucky parks. Enjoy fun outdoor adventure without the long lines of many destinations. Book now at parks.ky.gov.
Kentucky has one of the most expansive state park systems in the nation. For decades, the parks have been bringing people together for family reunions, fishing, hiking, and a wealth of other activities. What's your favorite memory of a Kentucky state park? Unfortunately, it takes more than governmental support to keep the parks vibrant. The Kentucky State Parks Foundation raises money to create educational programs for elementary school kids to connect them with nature, handicappable hiking trails, and the preservation of historical artifacts. Make a tax-deductible donation online at KentuckyStateParksFoundation.org.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by
ADA, heating and air. Trust ADA to be there when you need them the most. ADA is always on the way. Call them 859-519-6382. They provide 24-hour emergency service from ADA, heating and air. Partly sunny, high today 58, low tonight 39. Sunshine tomorrow, high of 70. On Thursday, rain showers likely, mostly cloudy, high of 67. Right now, 6:38 in the morning, 52 degrees. Larry Vaught, what's up with you today, buddy? Got Vaught's Views.
Vaught's Views on University of Kentucky Sports is on the air. Featuring seven-time Kentucky Sports Writer of the Year, Larry Vaught.
Kentucky coach John Calipari and players Antonio Reeves and Trey Mitchell will be at SEC Basketball Media Days Wednesday to talk about the upcoming season. The Cats expect to have a team capable of contending for a national title this year, and Calipari has made it clear just how much he likes this team. Blue Ribbon College Basketball Yearbook publisher Chris Dortch has UK ranked 11th in his preseason poll. Blue Ribbon Basketball Yearbook has Tennessee ranked 6th, and Dortch believes that coach Rick Barnes might have the best team he's had at Tennessee, especially with the addition of two needed shooters. Blue Ribbon has Arkansas ranked 8th, with Texas A&M 17th, Alabama 19th, and Mississippi State 25th. Dortch sees Arkansas with another loaded roster thanks to a lot of transfers once again, and believes Tennessee, Arkansas, and Kentucky all had the potential to compete for a national championship.
Vaught's Views will return in a moment.
Wildcat Chevrolet has always been known as your truck headquarters.
This is Michael Oliver with Wildcat Chevrolet Katy's. In October is truck season, and we do have a good selection of trucks, cars, and SUVs on the lot. New vehicles are coming in weekly, but it's a good idea to get your order in because they sell out quickly.
Wildcat Chevrolet Katy's, a short drive from anywhere and definitely worth the drive or visit to. Wildcat Chevrolet Katy's, check out their website daily for updates. It's wildcatchevrolet.com.
Blue Ribbon College baseball editor Chris Dortch does have one question about John Calipari's roster. He doesn't see a player like Anthony Davis or John Wall who could just dominate a game at any time. His publication did pick UK freshman Justin Edwards as the SEC newcomer of the year. Dortch expects Antonio Reeves to be one of the top scorers in college basketball this season, but does wonder if UK will have enough other consistent three-point shooting to make the kind of March Madness run the UK fans desperately want this season.
Find more from Larry at Your Sports Edge. Com.
Larry Von Vaught's views Mondays through Fridays in the Joe Show at this time, 238-9447, 238-WHIR, the phone number to call in this morning. A Georgia man was caught for excessive speeding, and the excessiveness of his speeding gave him the expensiveness of a ticket. How about this? Driving 35 mile per hour over the speed limit, a Georgia man was given a $1.4 million ticket. His name is Connor Cato. He was driving home through Savannah on September 2nd when the Georgia State Police caught him doing 90 in a 55. $1.4 million ticket for going 35 miles per hour over the speed limit. Sheesh. And he called this attorney's office to see if they could help him out.
Have you gotten a speeding ticket?
I sure have.
Is the fine $1.4 million?
It sure is.
Yeesh. Well, at the law offices of Dewey, help you and, we can't really do much for you. Yes, we've helped countless people get out of their speeding tickets, but if it's $1.4 million, you're on your own. Sorry. Just listen to this dissatisfied client.
I got a speeding ticket, and it was $1.4 million. So I called the law offices of Dewey, help you and, And when I told him how much the ticket was for, he just started laughing. Then he put me on a speaker so the rest of the staff could hear the amount and laugh at me, too. It was humiliating.
Oh, well, what can I say? $1.4 million is a little rich for my blood. So if you got a speeding ticket for $1.4 million, call the law offices of Dewey Help You and and we won't do nothing for you. Not making the law work for you. Se habla español.
There you go. Let's see what's going on in this morning's world of absolute good. Are you tired of the gloom and doom that saturates your daily news? Well, of course you are. I am right there with you, folks. These stories right here remind us of the silver line in the cloud over all of our heads. My way of sharing the good news with you, and hopefully you'll go do the same for somebody else. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up on the piano. It's Mr. Floyd Kramer. A little good news action for you on this Tuesday morning. Here we go. Story number one coming from Aetna, Pennsylvania, where resident Damian Komorowski is being hailed as a hero for bravely rescuing a man trapped inside a burning building. Despite this dangerous situation, he rushed into the burning home after hearing cries for help, successfully saving a man with Alzheimer's who was trapped upstairs. Komorowski humbly downplayed his actions and called for the community support for the affected residents. A good Samaritan saves a man with Alzheimer's trapped inside a building on fire. Here's a clip of Damian Komorowski saying that you can do what you can to help.
I'm lucky I didn't get asphyxiated, but I wasn't worried about me. And this ain't no superhero type of stuff. You just do what you can to help somebody.
Yeah, pretty cool. Story number two coming from New Hampshire, where resident David Eldridge had his DoorDash order delayed when police officer Chris Spitalair pulled over the delivery driver for a suspended license. Instead of leaving it at that, Officer Spitalair and fellow officer Robert McCon decided to complete the delivery after towing the driver's car. While Eldridge initially appreciated the help, he later wondered whether he should have tipped the officers for their good deed. Here's a clip of Brentwood Police Department Officer Chris Spitalair saying that they helped the driver with her DoorDash delivery.
Sometimes administrative issues can jam you up and it's not really your fault. And so we did what we could to try to help her on scene and then obviously help her with her DoorDash.
Yeah, story number three coming from Oklahoma City, where weeks before her sudden passing, Diane Sweeney of Oklahoma City told her nephew Rick Ingram about her desire that her 2016 Volkswagen Beetle be given away to someone at her funeral. Ingram announced the car giveaway in the local news, catching the attention of local 16-year-old Gabriella Bonham, who attended that funeral. A year later, with assistance from the funeral home staff, Bonham was chosen through a raffle to receive the car, ultimately fulfilling Sweeney's wish. Ingram believes that Bonham was the perfect person to receive the car and that his aunt would be pleased with how this whole thing turned out. A teenager wins a car by going to a stranger's funeral. New Hampshire cops finish a DoorDash driver's delivery after impounding the car. and a good Samaritan saves a man trapped inside a building on fire. That's what's going on in this morning's World of Absolute Good, folks. Hey, we got Sonus at Sunrise coming up next. Floyd Kramer, take it away, buddy. It's all yours. Spotlight's on you.
Hometown Radio Network would like to say congratulations to both the Hampton Inn and Holiday Inn and Suites. Here's Jasmine.
I'm here at the Hampton Inn by Hilton and Holiday Inn Express and Suites Danville. We definitely are award-winning. Recently, we both received awards for being in the top 1-5% of each of our brands, with Hilton and IHG ranking us number one with each of our brands here in Kentucky for 2022. We do this by filling the area with the light and warmth of our friendly, caring, and authentic hospitality. Come stay with us and see why our guests think we are so great.
Hi, this is Jenny at the Danville Nutrition Center. Get ready for the great outdoors with our Rootology sinus and allergy support products. Or try our DEET-free, all-natural bug repellents that are safe for the whole family. We even have a natural bug repellent for dogs, which is specially formulated to repel mosquitoes, flies, fleas, and ticks. Enjoy the great outdoors naturally by visiting your locally owned Danville Nutrition Center. We are located at 802 South 4th Street in Danville.
Bell beat.
To be that close really stinks.
Larson wins at Las Vegas.
It's nice to win and lock in and can focus on Phoenix. Everybody said I can't do it, couldn't do it, won't win. I just flat out just beat them.
Mark Garrow and PRN's Garage Pass.
Hey, airline travelers, let's say you have a problem and you need to change or cancel an existing airline reservation. What do you do? Well, SkyWatch is a free service that can help anyone with any airline reservation fix it. Whether you want to cancel it, change your dates, or add passengers, we can help fix your airline reservations so you get exactly what you need. We've updated our computer database and now have access to every airline around the globe. So now you can make one phone call, regardless of who booked your airline ticket, and we'll change it, cancel it, and fix it for you. We know the insider secrets to fixing reservations that the airlines don't want you to know about. So if you need to cancel, change, or modify an existing airline reservation, call SkyWatch right now. It's a free call, so let us fix it for you. 800-397-6805. 800-397-6805. 800-397-6805. That's 800-397-6805.
The South Point 400 at Las Vegas, the opening race in round three of the Cup Series playoff, came down to the last lap with Kyle Larson holding off Christopher Bell. Barely.
Got much closer than I wanted it to, but thankfully we were able to edge out a win, and thankfully, you know, Christopher ran us really clean there off of four.
And that allows Larson to be the first driver in the round of eight to guarantee he'll be one of the championship four in the season-ending race at Phoenix.
It's nice to win and lock in and can focus on Phoenix, but you can't really look too far ahead of yourself. You know, there's still two other races before then. Put a lot of pressure on myself and our team to not get complacent and treat every race like it means something.
Meanwhile, Bell was left to wonder, what if?
I feel like that was our chance. That was our chance to make Phoenix this year, and it slipped away from us. So we still got two more races to get ourselves in position. So I feel good about that, but to be that close really stinks.
Seven drivers are now left to fight for three spots in the championship four. After grabbing another top 10 finish, William Byron is now ranked second, only 11 points above the cut line.
Points are a lot tighter than we would want them to be, so we just got to have, you know, two good weeks, but you know, we kind of made the most out of what we had. Wish we could have gotten a little more stage points, but we'll take it.
Ranked third is Denny Hamlin plus four, and on the bubble, Martin Truex Jr. is three ahead of the cut line and Christopher Bell. Tyler Reddick is minus 15. Chris Buescher is down 23. And with Ryan Blaney getting disqualified, he's now 56 points underwater.
The NASCAR Championship runs through Atlanta Motor Speedway with two thrilling race weekends in 2024. It's win and you're in for the Ambetter Health 400. 400 spring weekend, February 23rd to the 25th. Come fall, the Cup Series playoffs begin with the Quaker State 400 available at Walmart on September 7th and 8th. The best way to experience the action is at the track, and you can get the best prices on season, weekend, and single-day tickets through October 31st. Go to AtlantaMotorspeedway.com to get yours today.
Shrugging off the doubters, Las Vegas native Riley Herbst pounded the field in a submission, winning the Alsco Uniforms 302 for his first Xfinity Series win in his 139th start.
We just beat everybody in the playoffs, trying to go to Phoenix. They all brought their best stuff, and we whooped them about 10 seconds. So everybody said I can't do it, couldn't do it, won't win, not good enough. I just flat out just beat them. So I'm pretty happy with myself. Happy with Stewart Haas Racing for sticking behind me.
Mark Garrow and PRN's Garage Pass, presented by eBay Motors. Burn rubber, not cash, by shopping on eBay Motors. ebaymotors.com.
Hi, this is Karen, and at ADA Heating and Air, we offer free estimates on replacements. We install American Standard heating and air conditioning equipment. Our employees do not work on commission, so you don't pay for unnecessary repairs. We offer the best pricing around. On average, we can save you 15%. We offer same or next day service. Financing is available on our website at adaheatingandair.com. Call ADA today for all your HVAC needs at 859-519-6382. ADA is on the way.
This Joe Show weather report brought to you by...
Thanks, Jack. Brought to you by Coel Collision Center in Danville. They're on Lebanon Road. After a wreck, tell the tow truck driver, take your vehicle to the experts, Brent and Davin, at Coel Collision Center, Lebanon Road, right here in Danville. Partly sunny skies, high today 58, low tonight of 39, sunshine tomorrow 70. Thursday rain showers likely, high of 67. Most of the rain comes Thursday night. Right now it's 6:52. 6:52 in the morning. It's 52 degrees here in Danville, Tuesday, October the 17th. Phone number to call in is 238-9447. Rick Dees always starts us off in the morning in this segment, looking at what app we should download in this morning's Planet of the Apps.
Welcome to the Planet of the Apps.
All right, listen, when it comes to losing weight or keeping your weight the same, it's all about the numbers. It's all about the calories. I have a friend who says, do I look like I've gained weight? And I say, what do the scales say? And then they slink out of the room. Do I look like I've gained weight? Don't do that. Get the app, Lose It. It's a calorie counter, but so much more. It's a barcode scanner. It tells you exactly the number of calories, also the nutrients. You can snap a picture of some food. It'll tell you that's 400 calories. You say, it couldn't be. Lose It says, yes, it is. So you can track nutrients, milestones, healthy living articles are included. And a huge food library database. I have it. It's called Lose It. It tells you the calories. And here's what's good about it. It gives you meal planning and targets. For example, you say, I'm going to eat more on this day. I'm going to this party. Or I'm going out to this restaurant. What do I do the other days? It tells you exactly what to do. Don't ask someone if you look like you've gained weight. Lose It will tell you that you're losing the weight. Lose It. It's free in the App Store. And Rick Dees right here every day in this molten magma. We call it the Planet of the Apps.
Thank you there, Rick Dees. The Planet of the Apps, Mondays through Fridays, right here on The Joe Show at this time, leads us into the Country Comic Spotlight this morning, where Eric Lydon is in the spotlight. Eric Lydon, who talks about traveling for comedy shows and getting on planes and things like that. Eric Lydon in this morning's Country Comic Spotlight. Here he is.
That's a really, really nice round of applause. But yeah, I gotta be honest with you, it always feels weird to me to get applause just for, you know, showing up for work. I genuinely appreciate it, but it's just, I haven't really done anything, you know. To me, it would be kind of like, you know, getting on a plane and clapping for the pilot because he took off. Whenever I have to fly somewhere, my wife always says, have a safe flight. And I always say, well, it's not my call. I'll mention it to the pilot when I swing by the cockpit on the way to the back of the plane. I know people who in first class, you know, pay more money to get first class, but I think the airline should allow people in coach to at least board the plane first, you know? Yay. Exactly. Because if you're flying coach, you know there are people doing better in life. I just don't think we should have to look at them right before we go on vacation. Now, and, speaking of travel, people think everybody I talk to about comedy and so forth, most people think that the hardest thing about being a comedian is getting up on stage in front of an audience. And that might be the case for some folks, but, you know, not me. I've always loved being the center of attention, no matter where I go. That's why funerals have always been a little harder for me. I'm not proud of that. Trust me. Just incredibly insecure, very desperate for attention, so I don't want to hear about somebody else for an hour. You know, Bill was a good man. Yeah, well, Bill didn't take off work today.
Eric Leiden in the Country Comic Spotlight, Rick Dees, and this morning's Planet of the Abs. Wendy's is the place to go for breakfast this morning. It's maybe the most important choice you make all day because you're going to have to choose two items out of the four that Wendy's has on their 2-for-3 Biggie Bundle. This is a deal that's here in Danville and Stanford and in Harrodsburg as well, where you can pick the sausage biscuit, the egg and cheese biscuit, the small seasoned potato, medium hot coffee. You pick two, you get it for $3. They also, at all those Wendy's locations, have the brand new Frosty Cream Cold Brew, available in vanilla, caramel, and chocolate. It's a morning maker. It's a post-lunch pick-me-up. It is a tasty late-night drink. It's available throughout the entire day. Wendy's in Danville, 2-for-3 Biggie Bundle. Make sure you swing by today, grab breakfast from Wendy's, and tell them you heard them this morning on the Joe Show. You can pick a sausage biscuit, an egg cheese biscuit, small seasoned potato, medium hot coffee, any two of those. You get them for $3 at Wendy's right here in Danville. It's 6:56 in the morning.
Every fan knows the advantages of playing on their home field.
Hi, I'm Patrick McClure from McClure, McClure & Bailey. Proud to be a lifelong resident of Danville and Boyle County.
Our firm can provide a variety of services to meet the legal needs of you and our community.
We're all local attorneys. We understand the needs of the people from Danville and Boyle County because we are people of Danville and Boyle County. Call the hometown team of McClure, McClure & Bailey at 236-8888.
Now located at 426 South 4th Street, just south of downtown Danville.
Go Ads, go Cats, and go Rebels.
This is an advertisement.
Hi, this is Jenny at the Danville Nutrition Center. Get ready for the great outdoors with our Rootology sinus and allergy support products. Or try our DEET-free, all-natural bug repellents that are safe for the whole family. We even have a natural bug repellent for dogs, which is specially formulated to repel mosquitoes, flies, fleas, and ticks. Enjoy the great outdoors naturally by visiting your locally owned Danville Nutrition Center. We are located at 802 South 4th Street in Danville.
Going out of town or anywhere in the world, stay in touch with WHIR on the internet at hometownlive.net. Powered by Kentucky WiMAX.
Old Red, Blake Shelton. All right, we're 2 minutes away from our top hour news here on the Joe Show, so how about we see what's breaking and trending here in this 6 o'clock hour. Some things that are going on here around the state, nation, and world. Starting off in Mexico, where the Sinaloa cartel, once controlled by El Chapo, says it has banned the production of fentanyl under penalty of death. The cartel is the main trafficker of fentanyl to the U.S., and experts say the announcement was spurred by a law enforcement crackdown of the drug. Guzman's four sons, known as the Chapitos, supposedly put the warning up on banners around the Mexican city of Culiacan, but U.S. law enforcement officials don't think the ban will do much to stop the flow of fentanyl into the country and could even boost the trafficking of heroin and cocaine even further. When someone's running a sweepstakes to avoid running up against laws against lotteries, a company or organization must give people a way to play without spending any money. You've seen the no purchase necessary to play notices on giveaways, but the current you can win $25,000 contest being run by Reese's may be in trouble. While it does have a no purchase necessary disclaimer, it's inside the package, which means someone would literally have to make a purchase to find out they didn't have to make a purchase. Hershey, the company that makes Reese's, said yesterday they have full details on the contest on the website and that some packages even have a QR code linking for more information. And hey, layoffs have hit LinkedIn. The app which is a job hiring app, said yesterday it's laying off about 700 workers across its engineering, product, talent, and finance teams, amounting to about 3% of its workforce. These layoffs follow over 700 that were announced back in May. LinkedIn owner Microsoft has also been laying off employees, but brought about 13,000 new ones on board when its $69 billion purchase of video game maker Activision Blizzard closed on Friday. That's what's breaking and trending here in the 6 o'clock hour. Coming up at the 7 o'clock hour on The Joe Show on 103.9 FM WHIR Danville. It's 7 o'clock in the morning. Top hour news is right now. We're talking Boyle County football coming up next.
This is the talk of the town, AM 1230 and now on FM 103.9 WHIR Danville, powered by Kentucky WiMAX.
It's 7 o'clock.
NBC News Radio, I'm Michael Kastner. The United States and Israel are working to provide humanitarian aid to Gaza. Secretary of State Antony Blinken made the announcement during his latest trip to Israel as fighting continues with the Palestinian militant group Hamas.
The United States and Israel have agreed to develop a plan that will enable humanitarian aid from donor nations and multilateral organizations to reach civilians in Gaza and them alone, including the possibility of creating areas to help keep civilians out of harm's way.
Blinken called it critical that aid begins arriving soon in Gaza. The news comes following the announcement that President Biden will be in Israel on Wednesday to meet with Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Attorney General Merrick Garland is opening a federal hate crimes investigation into the death of a child. Mark Mayfield explains.
The 6-year-old Chicago boy was stabbed over 24 times on Saturday. His mother was also injured in the attack that authorities say was carried out by the family's landlord. He's now charged with first-degree murder, aggravated battery with a deadly weapon, and 2 counts of a hate crime. Evidence gathered suggests the family was targeted due to their Islamic faith and the Israel-Hamas war. In a statement issued late Sunday night, President Biden said both he and First Lady Jill Biden were sickened to learn of the brutal murder. He added, "There is no place in America for hate against anyone." I'm Mark Mayfield.
Hundreds attended the funeral yesterday for the boy, including Governor Pritzker and the mayor of Chicago. A vote for the new Speaker of the House is expected today. Ryan Nobles reports from Capitol Hill, where a vote on Representative Jim Jordan of Ohio will happen after the House convenes at noon Eastern.
Jordan is increasingly confident that he is almost at that magic number of 217 votes. He flipped a number of Republicans who had said previously that they would never vote for him, but still maybe a little bit short.
Michael Kastner, NBC News Radio.
Kentucky is a special place. I see it everywhere I go. I'm Andy Beshear. We've been through a lot these past 4 years, but Kentuckians are the hardest working, most resilient people I know. We face down impossible challenges, and we've come out stronger on the other side. I will always show up for Kentucky families because we look out for each other. We're rebuilding homes and whole new neighborhoods from natural disasters because we have a responsibility to our fellow Kentuckian. We're growing our economy at a record pace, creating thousands of new good-paying jobs. Unemployment has never been lower. And we've cut the income tax by 10% in a fiscally responsible way. There's still work to do. That's why my education plan includes well-deserved and necessary raises for our public school teachers. We've turned the corner, and we're moving forward. Let's keep it going. I'm Andy Beshear, and I approve this message.
Former President Donald Trump heads back to New York City today to a courtroom where his businesses are the center of a $250 million civil fraud trial. New York Attorney General Letitia James accuses Trump and the Trump Organization of overvaluing assets in order to get more favorable loans. While Trump isn't required to be present, he's told reporters he goes so he can point out how, in his words, corrupt the entire system is. It's billed as the happiest place on earth, but for a few moments, Disneyland looked like a WWE cage match. Phil Ferrara explains.
And after all, the spotlight was on Fantasyland. Kids and strollers stuck in the middle as parents went toe-to-toe. Disneyland security says two adults throwing roundhouses while bumping into baby strollers. The fistfight happening near the famous spinning teacup ride. Other adults joined in. Officials say one man who was on the ground kicked. No word on what caused the melee, but authorities say fights have become increasingly regular occurrences at Disney theme parks and other amusement parks across the country.
A Ring doorbell video shows a Kent, Washington couple narrowly escaping a gunman. Brad Ford reports.
Kent police say early Sunday morning, a woman and her husband arrived home and got out of their car when they saw a man armed with a gun and wearing a mask come up from behind. They ran into their home and slammed the door before the suspect could reach them. The surveillance video shows the man try to open the door. When he sees the Ring camera, he uses the gun to break it and remove it. Police are trying to identify the suspect and whether two similar incidents are related.
Four inmates are on the run after escaping from a Georgia jail. The Bibb County Sheriff's Office says they fled through a damaged window at a courthouse detention center. It's about 85 miles south of Atlanta early Monday morning. All of the escapees got into a blue Dodge Challenger and took off. Michael Kastner, NBC.
Hey, it's Joe Pags. Make plans to join us for the show. We're bringing the top news stories that are affecting you, the top stories from social media, pop culture stories, could be in sports. Maybe we'll sing a song or two or three or make fun of somebody that you want us to make fun of. That plus, of course, a big part of the program is you calling in. Look, we can agree, we can debate, we can yell at each other, we can sing a song together. We do it all right here on the Joe Pags Show, Monday through Friday from 6 to 9 on WHIR AM 1230 and online at hometownlive.net.
Good morning to you folks. Tuesday, October the 17th. It's 51 degrees right here in Danville and looking at 58 as your high. Forecast is coming your way. News brought to you by Stuart Powell Ford.
Hi, this is Fred Sizemore, General Manager at Stuart Powell Ford Mazda here in Danville, where we make it easy to do business with us. I want to let you know that we are now offering free pickup and delivery in our quick lane within 20 miles of Danville. Give us a call at 859-238-1190. We will schedule your vehicle for pickup, perform the service requested, and return it to you.
Come to Stuart Powell, we can do business. Stuart Powell,
Ford Lincoln Mazda.
This is a Hometown Radio Network information update. Ephraim McDowell Health is now helping fight food insecurity with the Ephraim McDowell Food Assistance Partnership Program. The program provides individual boxes of non-perishable food for food insecure patients and their families upon discharge from any of Ephraim's three hospitals, Ephraim McDowell Regional Medical Center in Danville, Fort Logan Hospital in Stanford, and Hagen Hospital in Harrodsburg. The food boxes include shelf-stable meal items that are easy to cook and is intended to feed a patient and their family for up to 2 days. Families can participate in the Food Assistance Partnership based on their responses to a survey they take when they're admitted to the hospital. It's Frank X. Walker Creative Arts Festival Week at the Danville School System this week. The event started yesterday and continued today with a Frank X. Walker Artist Talk for the middle and high school students. Tomorrow with the Frank X. Walker readings at Hogsett and Tolliver. And then Thursday and Friday with the creative art workshops in the schools. There will also be an opening reception and a Frank X. Walker visual art exhibit beginning today and going through October 28th. Frank X. Walker is a Danville High School graduate who was appointed Poet Laureate of Kentucky in 2013, the first African-American to hold that position. And two school resource officers will have their own SRO vehicles thanks to a donation to Lincoln County Schools. The Ohio County Sheriff's Office recently donated two used police cars to Lincoln County Schools and the Stanford Police Department. Lincoln Schools says the vehicles will be used for their school resource officers. The first phase of repairs to the Anderson Dean Park pool have been approved. The Harrodsburg Herald reports that at their last park board meeting, the board of directors approved a $175,400 bid from American Leak Detection of Mount Washington for phase one of those pool repairs. The Anderson Dean Park pool had been closed since June after officials learned the pool had leaked 1 million gallons of water in its first week it was open. And remember, today is the pop-up driver's licensing program in Lincoln County. Last year, the state changed where you get your licenses and renew them by making regional driver's license offices. However, it's still inconvenient for some to get to those other counties. So to make it easier, they're hosting pop-up programs. In our area, Lincoln County will host a pop-up driver's license program today at the Lincoln County Public Library. Meanwhile, Mercer County will have theirs on Thursday at the Mercer County Courthouse. You can register online at the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet website, drive.ky.gov. I'm Joe Mathis.
This morning's local news was a service of Stuart Powell Ford Lincoln Mazda on the bypass in Danville and online at stuartpowell.com.
Time out for sports this weekend with
Sports Map Radio Network
on WHIR AM 1230.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Hey, good morning. You're heading to the airport, right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now, but I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code TAXI for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code TAXI for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code TAXI.
Hi, this is Jenny at the Danville Nutrition Center. Get ready for the great outdoors with our Rootology sinus and allergy support products. Or try our DEET-free, all-natural bug repellents that are safe for the whole family. We even have a natural bug repellent for dogs, which is specially formulated to repel mosquitoes, flies, fleas, and ticks. Enjoy the great outdoors naturally by visiting your locally owned Danville Nutrition Center. We are located at 802 South 4th Street in Danville.
This Joe Show weather report brought to you by...
Thank you there, Jackie Boy. Brought to you by our friends over at Cattleman's Roadhouse. Treat yourself to a delicious meal at Cattleman's. Their burgers are all natural beef, certified, humanely raised, never any antibiotics. Cattleman's Roadhouse, Danville Bypass. A great steak truly is just the beginning. All right, you get sunshine. High of 60, low tonight 40. Sunshine tomorrow 70. On Thursday, mostly cloudy. 67 is your high. It's 7:11 in the morning, and it's 51 degrees, and it's Boyle County Rebel Football Talk with head coach Justin Haddix, brought to you by Dexter and Reitmeyer Insurance.
Folding a fitted sheet, programming the thermostat, matching your socks. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with an auto owner's insurance independent agent, getting the right coverage for your home doesn't have to be one of them. So you can get back to more important things, like finding that missing sock. That's simple human sense.
Ask Dexter and Reitmeyer Insurance Agency in Danville if auto owners make sense for you. Call me, Mark Dexter, or Chris Reitmeyer at 236-6686.
And we welcome on to the show Boyle County head football coach Justin Haddix. Good morning, coach. How are you?
Doing good. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing great, Coach. Appreciate you being on here this morning and talking Rebel football. You all are hosting Wayne County on Friday, Coach, the Wayne County Cardinals, and looking at a chance to sweep the district and clinch back-to-back home playoff games, assuming that you win, you know, the first one, and a lot to play for this Friday against Wayne County, Coach. Let's start off with this Wayne County defense. What do you expect to see defensively out of this Wayne County team on Friday, Coach?
They give you a little unorthodox look sometimes. They give you an odd front, and then they'll give you a four-man front, an even front, some things that they do. So we'll just kind of – we'll see what they give us. We're kind of in games. Sometimes you don't know how they're going to line up. We have to adjust. We prepare for everything. So
yeah.
They do a good job at what they do and kind of make it unorthodox where – certain things work and certain things don't, the way that they play their coverage and roll it sometimes. So we've got to do a good job.
Is there any doubt, Coach, and we're going to talk about this guy probably every day for the rest of the week, but is there any doubt who their best player is? Antoine Dumford, who plays offense, he plays defense. He's scored 20 touchdowns this year, 11 rushing, 8 receiving, 1 kickoff return. He has an interception as well. It seems like their team kind of revolves around what number 5 does for them.
Yeah, he's a really good player. He'll play defense too. They move him around. He plays inside receiver. He plays outside receiver. They snap it to him in the Wildcat. He played quarterback last year, so I'm sure they have some things that they do with him specifically with the offense. So he's definitely a really good football player.
This is a team coach that started off 5-0. Since then, they're 1-2, and they've given up 113 points in their last three games. Back-to-back games against Taylor County and Lincoln County, they gave up 90 total, 50 to Taylor, 40 to Lincoln County. What is it, Coach, over the last three games? Have you seen anything that's changed for them watching film? I mean, they look like one of the top teams, maybe not necessarily in 4A, so to say, but they were 5-0, right? Like, they were rolling, then suddenly over the last 3 weeks, they're 1-2. Has it just been a step up in competition?
Coach Guffey, Tyler Guffey, he played quarterback there, and we've always – Sean Thompson, the former coach there, are buddies, and I always knew Tyler when he started coaching, and we've always kept in touch. And I talked with him in the past couple of weeks. They just had some injuries, and just they're thin in certain spots. And you know, that's high school football. It's what you're going to get. So, you know, I think maybe they may have had a couple guys go down in the secondary, but, you know, also playing in a tougher, moving up in different districts, you know, you start playing a little better teams too, and it, you know, exposes some things. But he does a great job. They're a young football team. They started a freshman, a sophomore linebacker. They started a freshman quarterback. So, and then Dunford, I think, is just a junior. So they've got some. They'll have a lot of those guys back, you know, next year too. But they're in the thick of it right now.
Boyle County head football coach Justin Haddix. Coach, what do you work on in practice on this Tuesday afternoon after school?
Today's our defensive day, so we'll be going. Our scout team, our second team, will be running their offense, going against our defense and installing what we want and just getting after and competing today.
There you go. Coach, before we let you go, we got some candy matchups for you to vote on. Yesterday, Snickers moved on, beating 100 grand M&Ms with a narrow win over Twizzlers. So we have Snickers and M&Ms that'll battle it out for a chance to go to the Final Four. But let's hop to another quadrant here this morning, Coach. Let's go to the bottom left. We have two matchups for you. First of all, the number two seed in the left-hand side of the bracket, that's Twix, going up against the seventh-seeded Starburst in the 2-7 matchup. Coach, who do you have?
I think we gotta go Starburst.
Starburst. I have this theory, Coach, where younger people are more apt and likely to vote for chewy, fruity, gummy candy than older people are. So congratulations, Coach. You are a young person because you voted frequently for the gummy, chewy, fruity candy.
Well, I think we've got a bunch of chocolate on there. We got to switch it up.
Okay, I understand that. That makes sense. So Starburst, a 1-0 lead over Twix. And, Coach, the second matchup in the bottom left quadrant, Three Musketeers, the 11 seed, which upset the sixth-seeded Nestle Crunch in the first round. They go up against the classic Hershey bar, the 3 seed. Who you have, Hershey bars or Three Musketeers?
Hershey.
Hershey? All right, so Hershey bars and Starburst, the two votes for Coach Haddix. Coach, appreciate you being on. We'll talk to you again tomorrow morning, okay?
All right, thank you. Go Rebels.
All right, bye. That's Boyle County head football coach Justin Haddix. Rick is back here booing him. Rick, that's not nice of him. Oh, he's not booing Coach Haddix. He's booing his choice of Hershey bars over Three Musketeers. See, Rick's like, I knew Rick was a Three Musketeer guy. I've heard him talk about him before. But I'm not sure that there's many people that could literally tell you what a Three Musketeers tastes like. Because people don't eat them frequently enough, and they don't hand them out frequently enough. Which is why I was shocked it beat Nestle Crunch. I think Nestle Crunch is overrated myself. But still, at least I know what a crunch tastes like. I couldn't tell. You could do like a blind taste test between Three Musketeers, maybe like 100 grand, and a whatchamacallit. And I wouldn't know the difference between the three. So, see, that's the difference between being an iconic candy. Like, you could give me a Snickers and a Butterfinger, and I know those two. And maybe you mix a Three Musketeers in there, and the only reason I know which one the Three Musketeers is because I can eliminate it by knowing which one Butterfinger and Snickers is. But I can't tell you what a Three Musketeers tastes like because I don't eat them frequently enough. Hershey bars gets a vote. Starburst gets a vote over Twix from Coach Haddix. We're talking with Danville Coach Frank Parks. He's coming up right after our quick look at sports with Steve.
This Steve Bertram Sports Report is a service of Stuart Powell Ford Lincoln Mazda on the Danville Bypass and online at stuartpowell.com.
Hi, this is Fred Sizemore, General Manager at Stuart Powell Ford Mazda here in Danville, where we make it easy to do business with us. I want to let you know that we are now offering free pickup and delivery in our quick lane within 20 miles of Danville. Give us a call at 859-238-1190. We will schedule your vehicle for pickup, perform the service requested, and return it to you.
Come to Stuart Powell. We can do business.
Ford Lincoln Mazda.
Hello, Central Kentucky. I'm Steve Bertram with sports. Last night in the opening round of the girls' state high school soccer tournament, 12th region champ Boyle County defeated 11th region champ Madison Central 2-0 at Rebel Stadium. The Lady Rebels now advance to the Elite Eight Thursday night. Boyle has posted shutouts in 5 of its 6 postseason games. There were 2 games in baseball's league championship series Monday. In the ALCS, Texas jumped out to a 5-1 lead, then held off Houston for a 5-3 win and a 2-0 lead in the series. Game 3 is in Arlington tomorrow night. In Game 1 of the NLCS, Philadelphia jumped out on top of Arizona 5-0, then held off the Diamondbacks to win Game 1 5-3. Game 2 starters tonight, Aaron Nola for the Phillies against Merrill Kelly for the Diamondbacks. In the NFL Monday night special, Dallas defeated the LA Chargers 20-17. The Cowboys improved 4-2, while the Chargers dropped to 2-3. Georgia remains number 1 in the AP College Football Top 25 this week. Louisville fell to 21st, and Kentucky dropped out. The Bulldogs are followed in the top 5 by Michigan, Ohio State, Florida State, and Oklahoma. Other SEC schools ranked this week are Alabama at number 11, Ole Miss 13th, Tennessee 17th, LSU 19th, and Missouri is 20th. Kentucky has an open date this week and will host number 17 Tennessee on October 28th. Boyle County shortstop Cam Owens has committed to playing baseball at the University of Kentucky. Owens, a rising senior in a class of 24, hit .481 last year with 9 homers and 40 ribbies. We'll have the Kentucky men's basketball blue-white scrimmage on the air this Saturday from Northern Kentucky University. Pre-game show start at 5:30. Tip-off is at 6 on Z105. All proceeds from the game go to Eastern Kentucky Flood Relief and Western Kentucky Tornado Relief. That's sports. God bless America. I'm Steve Bertram on the Hometown Radio Network.
Lee's Famous Recipe of Danville's honored to have served this community since 1972. They're excited to announce they are offering even more $5.99 lunch specials. Choose from Lee's two-piece breast strip, two-piece dark chicken, chicken slider, or a barbecue chicken sandwich. All specials come with a side of your choice along with a regular drink and an apple pie or cookie. Wednesday's Customer Appreciation Day. Come on in and ask for the Wednesday special. 3 pieces of Famous Crispy or strips, 2 sides of your choice. Hot Homestyle Buttermilk Biscuit, all a dollar off the regular price. Don't feel like cooking tonight? Try one of their family meals. They come in options of 8, 12, 16, or 20-piece selections with your choice of sides. They specialize in catering, so if you need to cater a wedding, office party, funeral, birthday party, or any other special event, call them at 859-236-8777, 236-8777 for a free quote. Let them do all the work for you. They're located at 610 South 4th Street. Drive through or come on in. Lee's Famous Recipe, serving the best chicken in Danville for over 40 years.
You have a loved one needing to find help, hope, and healing today. The first step to a happier, healthier life is to call the Isaiah House Real Hope for Addiction. Isaiah House provides care for men and women, locations throughout Kentucky, resetting one's life through healing, opportunity, education, and employment support for lifelong success. When you feel once to the point of rock bottom and needs help, hope, and healing, call the Isaiah House anytime, 24 hours a day.
Wasson's Tractor 2, your local Kubota equipment dealer, wants to help you deliver a job done right. That's why they want you to know that the new Kubota inventory is arriving driving daily. You have work to do. They have the reliability and durability and versatile lineup to help you do it all. Visit Lawson's Tractor 2 today for all your equipment needs. Lawson's Tractor 2, 4 miles south of Danville on Highway 127, open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, and Saturday, 8 to noon. Lawson's Tractor 2.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cardtown Kia.
It's your choice. The new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cardtown Kia and CardtownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 to its sign, 2023 Kia Sorento, 2556 to its sign, $349 down, $349 per month, 36-month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, dock, and acquisition fees with approved credit. No security deposit required. All incentives to deal with placement, non-include dealer, added option, see dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st, 2023.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by
Danville Auto Body Shop for top-of-the-line collision and auto body repair. Hand to the mechanics at Danville Auto Body Shop, 315 Delahaye. Call 236-2299 for an appointment. That's 236-2299 for Danville Auto Body Shop. Partly sunny, high today 58, low tonight 39, sunshine tomorrow 70. Rain showers are likely on Thursday, 67. Friday, showers, thunderstorm possibility, high of 62. It's 7:25 in the morning. It is 52 degrees. We're talking Admiral football with Danville head coach Frank Parks right now.
Configuring the Bluetooth, deciding who controls the music, remembering where you parked. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with an auto owner's insurance independent agent, getting the right coverage for your vehicle doesn't have to be one of them. So you can get back to more important things, like remembering if you're on the third or fourth level of the parking garage. That's simple human sense.
Ask Dexter and Reitmeyer Insurance Agency in Danville if auto owners make sense for you. Call me, Mark Dexter, or Chris Reitmeyer at 236-6686.
And we welcome onto the show Danville head football coach Frank Parks, Jr. Good morning, Coach. How are you?
Good morning. I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing great, Coach. Appreciate you being on here this morning and talking to us about Admiral football. You're going against the Breathitt County Bobcats on Friday night at Admiral Stadium in the final district game of the year, Coach. And tell you what, there's quite a bit to play for in this game, right? This is the difference between the 3 seed and the 4 seed, if I'm not mistaken, in you all's district, Coach. So you got Breathitt County; they're 1-1. You all are 0-2, but a win tonight or win Friday would make you all 1-2 and make them 1-2, and you all would have the head-to-head tiebreaker over them. So pretty big game on Friday night, isn't it?
Oh, yes, definitely. You know, one, you want to get that district win, and like you said, two, opportunity to play for a 3 seed versus a 4 seed.
Yeah, and that first game in the playoffs as the potential 4 seed or 3 seed, big difference when you travel to those different places with the districts that you all are kind of considered sister districts with. So you got Breathitt County on Friday. Let's talk about this Breathitt County defense. They've had games this year. They've looked pretty good. They've had games this year, Coach, where they have looked pretty shaky at times. They gave up 48 in their season opening game to Belfry. Now we know Belfry is a really good team. Gave up 41 to Johnson Central, another really good team. But they've had games where they've given up 13. They've given up 14. They've given up 6. So what do you expect to see out of the Breathitt County defense that you face up against Friday, Coach?
Well, you know, they have been in that 3-4 odd look, and they play hard. And, you know, it's not so much of speed, but they play very hard. And they're not super big up front. They got a couple big guys. But, like I said, they're going to be physical, and they well coached, and they're going to be where they're supposed to be, and they're going to play physical football.
Coach, we know against some of these district opponents, Leslie County being one, maybe, I don't know so much of Somerset, but I'm going to ask you about this upcoming game Friday, about speed being an advantage for you all. Do you feel like you have the speed advantage against Breathitt County?
Yeah, I think, you know, if we can get out on the prem, the speed advantage with Braden. You know, you got Braden, and, you know, if Bubba can get all the way back healthy with that growing pool, that, you know, you got two guys that can run with most any one, so you will have a little bit of a speed advantage.
Coach, you all have been dealt a tough hand practically all year long with guys going down and injuries, and that's kind of affected the depth. How much, Coach, goes into you all's practices where it comes down to you're kind of shifting guys around and getting them familiar in positions that they really haven't played before, or you didn't think you really have to use them coming into this year because injuries have really decimated some of the games in the roster that you had?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, from beginning of the year, we had kids have been out that we was looking forward to playing certain positions, and we had to shift kids. And, you know, just like last week, we had to put Xavier Lavelle at a little outside linebacker spot, who has been mostly in the secondary all year. And, you know, it's been a shuffle, and, you know, but the guys have really really did what they could and sacrificed to, you know, help the team however they could. So we have a lot of moving parts, and I don't know if there's been a game yet where it's been maybe the same 11 back-to-back weeks and defensively and maybe offensively. But,
yeah.
You know, I'm just, you know, proud of those guys to continue to come back and play hard, and whatever role we need them in, they accept it and they give us all they get.
Yeah, it's a good point. I mean, there probably has not been a game all year long where you could pencil in the same starting 11 on offense or defense in back-to-back games. And that makes things really tough on you all, doesn't it? Trying to figure out as a coaching staff where guys feel comfortable playing. And remember, if you move one guy, someone else has got to be put in that spot where that guy just moved from. So it's not just moving one person to one position. It shuffles the entire 11 on offense or defense.
Right, and that's the thing. And then you have guys who, you know, maybe getting familiar and accustomed to a spot, then there's another shift. So now they playing in a position that, you know, they necessarily may not be comfortable in. But and it's tough because yesterday we were talking about, you know, personnel issues, who we can put where and who can play where. And, you know, it makes tough for practice too, because you don't know who's going to be able to play on Friday at this moment in time. So you just kind of trying to, you know, do the best you can by putting the people in the spots that could help us out the most.
Yeah, one of those spots, Coach, that you got to figure out is your long snapper and defensive end. And you posted yesterday that Sasha Wade would miss the rest of the season. And I tell you what, is there any more underappreciated role on a football team than long snapper? It's such a specialized skill to have. And it's almost like being a sound technician at church. The guy or lady knows how to do it, and the only way you know the person is there is if they mess up. And it's the same thing with a long snapper, right? Like, that's such a specialized skill to where people can get college offers just to be a long snapper, and now you're looking for a long snapper to replace Sasha Wade, Coach. Tell us about that.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I think sometimes people take it for granted or that's not in these roles, but, you know, that long snapper is so vital, you know, to the whole operation. And as you see at the end of first half last week, that was a big difference too. You know, we got one of our best weapons in Caleb that we couldn't use to, you know, change the field at the end of the half because, you know, our long snapper was out. And, yes, we had, you know, Keegan, who's a backup, but he hasn't got the reps. So, you know, it was – I didn't want to put him in that situation until after halftime where he could get some more practice reps and then have to go on such a tough situation. But then he ended up getting banged up. So now you just, you know, very rare that anybody have a third guy that long
yeah.
snaps. You know, so
yeah.
It was you could just see the importance of Sasha and his ability to long snap and short snap, and how it plays a significant role if you don't have a guy that is efficient in that role.
I'm not sure there's any roster that has a third-string long snapper, Coach. That's a good point, especially on the high school level. When you need three long snappers in the roster, that's when you know you've had some injuries take place. But, Coach, you got Breathitt County again Friday night, 7:30 kickoff. Luckily, it's a home game. Fortunately, been some long trips the last couple of weeks, but get to play in front of the Admiral fans at Admiral Stadium. What are you working on in practice today, Coach?
Today will be a, you know, offensive day, and, you know, we're going to get Braylon a lot of reps and make sure we implement some things that he can do well, you know, use his athleticism, and, you know, hopefully we can tamper some things that, you know, he feel comfortable doing today. So it'll be an offensive day, and we'll get a lot of good special teams working in to fill some of these boys that we got through some of these injuries.
There you go, Danville head coach Frank Parts. Coach, before you go, I've got two candy matchups for you to help determine as we move on to the Elite Eight. We're in the Sweet 16 right now. Yesterday's matchups, Snickers, a win over 100 grand. M&M's, a win over Twizzlers. Those two candies will match up in the Elite Eight now, but we go to another quadrant, Sweet 16 matchups. First one, Coach, Twix, which got an easy win over Airheads in the first round. Twix against Starburst. Which one do you go with, Coach? Twix as the 2 seed, Starburst as the 7 seed.
Twix.
Twix ties it up with Starburst. 1-1 in that 2-7 matchup. The other matchup, Coach, Three Musketeers, the 11 seed, versus the classic Hershey Bars as the 3 seed.
Hershey Bar.
So Hershey takes a 2-0 lead over Three Musketeers, and the Twix and Starburst matchup is tied up at 1 apiece. Coach, appreciate you being on. Good luck with practice. We'll talk to you again tomorrow morning, okay?
All right.
All right, Coach. Yes, sir. Bye. That's Danville head football coach Frank Parts Jr. The Admirals taking on Breathitt County. The Rebels of Boyle County taking on Wayne County. Both of those games at home this Friday on the Hometown Radio Network. We'll see what's going on with Jessica Besson in the Mercer County Extension Office coming up. And I just got confirmation, 7:50 this morning, we'll talk with Boyle County girls soccer coach Brian Deem. Lady Rebels won yesterday 2-0 over Madison Central to advance to the Elite Eight in the state tournament. We'll talk with Coach Deem about that coming up right after our local news and our County Agents Corner.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cardtown Kia.
It's your choice. The new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cardtown Kia and CardtownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 to its sign, 2023 Kia Sorento, $25.56 to its sign, $349 down, $349 per month, 36 month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, dock, and acquisition fees with approved credit. No security deposit required. All incentives to dealer price may not include dealer added options. See dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st, 2023.
This is Randy Gip Graham. If you want to start your weekend off in a winning way, propelling you into a new work week, then join with our team every Saturday morning at 7 o'clock on the Kentucky Power Hour. Sure, we talk current events, politics, a little sports, and a lot about leadership, but with you, the listener, in mind. So start your day off in a winning way. Right here on the Happy Station, WHIR.
The Kentucky Power Hour on AM 1230 and FM 103.9.
This is a Hometown Radio Network information update. Ephraim McDowell Health is now helping fight food insecurity with the Ephraim McDowell Food Assistance Partnership Program. The program provides individual boxes of non-perishable food for food insecure patients and their families upon discharge from any of Ephraim's 3 hospitals, Ephraim McDowell Regional Medical Center in Danville, Fort Logan Hospital in Stanford, and Hagen Hospital in Harrodsburg. The food boxes include shelf-stable meal items that are easy to cook and is intended to feed a patient and their family for up to 2 days. Families can participate in the Food Assistance Partnership based on their responses to a survey they take when they're admitted to the hospital. It's Frank X. Walker Creative Arts Festival Week at the Danville School System this week. The event started yesterday and continued today with a Frank X. Walker Artist Talk for the middle and high school students. Tomorrow with the Frank X. Walker readings at Hogsett and Tolliver, and then Thursday and Friday with the creative art workshops in the schools. There will also be an opening reception and a Frank X. Walker visual art exhibit beginning today and going through October 28th. Frank X. Walker is a Danville High School graduate who was appointed Poet Laureate of Kentucky in 2013, the first African-American to hold that position. And 2 school resource officers will have their own SRO vehicles thanks to a donation to Lincoln County Schools. The Ohio County Sheriff's Office recently donated 2 used police cars to Lincoln County Schools and the Stanford Police Department. Lincoln Schools says the vehicles will be used for their school resource officers. The first phase of repairs to the Anderson Dean Park pool have been approved. The Harrodsburg Herald reports that at their last park board meeting, the board of directors approved a $175,400 bid from American Leak Detection of Mount Washington for phase one of those pool repairs. The Anderson Dean Park pool had been closed since June after officials learned the pool had leaked 1 million gallons of water in its first week it was open.
And remember, today is the pop-up driver's licensing program in Lincoln County. Last year, the state changed where you get your licenses and renew them by making regional driver's license offices. However, it's still inconvenient for some to get to those other counties. So to make it easier, they're hosting pop-up programs. In our area, Lincoln County will host a pop-up driver's license program today at the Lincoln County Public Library. Meanwhile, Mercer County will have theirs on Thursday at the Mercer County Courthouse. You can register online at the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet website, drive.ky.gov. I'm Joe Mathis.
Hey, Joe, did you know Big Deals has got something new?
Where can I save money now, Radio Rick?
We've got the Anderson Lifestyle Boutique in Danville. Buy a $50 gift certificate for a Big Deals price of just $35.
Sounds awesome. What do they have?
They offer jewelry, apparel, gifts, and home decor. They do embroidery and monogramming. Come and see their selection of comfortable jeans, heavy canvas bags, lamps, art, scratch-made soap scents, natural soy candles. Find the perfect curtains, blinds, and shutters for your home.
Sounds great. I know where I can get my wife a gift and save money. Please don't tell her.
It's up to me. Joe, you like to eat, don't you?
You bet.
Save money at the Big City Pizza Company in Danville. Another new way to save.
I'd love to have some of their three cheese mac and cheese pizza.
Well, get over to hometownlive.net and save on Big City Pizza with a $10 gift certificate for just $7.
I'm on it. Pizza night tonight at the Mathis House.
You, too, can save with more big deals at hometownlive.net. Lots of discounts like Bread of Life, Sweets by Cindy, O'Charlie's, Applebee's, the old bus station, and A&L Accessories.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by...
It's brought to you by our friends over at Dexter and Reitmeyer Insurance, your local independent insurance agency. Proudly representing the Auto Owners Insurance Company, call Mark or Chris. He'd love to give you a free quote. Dexter Reitmeyer Insurance, 236-6686. Ask if auto owners make sense for you. Partly sunny, a high today of 58, low tonight 39. Tomorrow, sunshine 69. Thursday, rain showers likely, high of 67. And Friday, showers likely, possibly a thunderstorm, and a high Friday of 62. 7:40 in the morning. And Jessica Besson joins us this morning for the County Agents Corner. Good morning, Jessica. How are you?
Hey, Joe. I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great, Jessica. Appreciate you being on here this morning, giving us the County Agents Corner, brought to you by Bluegrass South Livestock Market.
Get the top price for your livestock. Take them to the Bluegrass South Livestock Market, where they have drop-off hours to fit the busy farmer's needs. Selling your livestock a profitable and a pleasant experience. Save the hassle of a long haul. Sell your livestock at the Bluegrass South Livestock Market, 277 Courtier Road in Stanford. Call Bluegrass South Livestock Market at 606-365-0665. Bluegrass South Livestock Market in Stanford.
Here's Jessica Besson.
All right, thanks, Joe. Well, right now through, getting into late October through December is the perfect time to start planting trees. And I'm actually getting ready to go out on a home and farm visit this afternoon to talk about planting a bunch of trees at Brightleaf Golf Course and helping them select some. So I thought this would be a perfect opportunity to talk about selecting trees this time of year. So we plant trees this time of year because they lose less moisture during the fall days. The fall days are shorter. The outdoor temperatures are cooler. We usually have some rainfall. These conditions help retain the soil moisture so the plants can settle into their new location. Also, many of them are deciduous that we're planting, so that means they lose their leaves in the fall and the demand for water is less. Now, if you're wanting to plant something that's an evergreen that will keep its leaves all year during the fall and winter, it's best to plant them in the early spring and perhaps really early fall, so their root system has enough time to develop before it slows down during the winter months. So how do you go about planting your tree? First, choose the right tree for the right place. You don't want to plant a tree that's going to get extremely large right on top of your house or planting it underneath power lines. So think about that. It might be a nice little, maybe 6 feet tall tree, 6 foot tall tree when you purchase it, but, is it eventually going to become 60 feet tall when it fully matures? So ornamentals should not be planted any deeper than they grew in their own container. So just dig a hole at least 2 to 3 times is the width of it, of that root ball, and then backfill it with the native soil. You don't want to add any potting soil or anything else to it. Just the soil you dig the hole with, you can put it right back in. Apply a 2 to 3 inch layer of mulch. The trees will really appreciate that. Just make sure you don't pile it up around the trunk because that will encourage rotting. We see that a lot in parking lots that they call volcano mulch, and we definitely want to avoid that because that's a quick way to kill a newly planted tree. But that weed the mulch layer will help conserve moisture, discourage weed growth, and then in the spring, it'll also prevent from lawnmowers or mowers hitting your new trees, because that's another way to quickly take out a tree with weed eater damage. No need to fertilize newly planted trees or shrubs during their whole first year. This will cause excessive vegetative growth, and also often your roots will not develop, which can prevent cause survival to decrease of your trees. So inadequate moisture during drying periods is usually the main threat of the survival of it. So be sure to soak the ground thoroughly after transplanting. And even though we're going through the winter, you know, check it periodically and give them a little water every now and then to provide sufficient moisture, and hope that they will come through and survive in throughout the spring. So that's today's farm news. Thanks for tuning into our program. Join us each weekday at this time for the County Agent's Corner, a service of the Mercer, Boyle, Garrett, and Lincoln County UK Cooperative Extension offices.
Thank you for that, Jessica Besson, giving us a lesson this morning on the County Agent's Corner, brought to you by Bluegrass South Livestock Market. All right, Jessica, before you go, I've got some random facts you may not know, but I want you to know, so I'm going to let you know. Jessica, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go, Jessica. Fact number one. Both China and Japan, ever been to either one of those two countries?
I have not, but my brother was in China.
He was in China for a while. Did he know that China and Japan, but China for him because he was there, both have Eiffel Towers, and they're both taller than the one in Paris. They aren't exact copies. They're among dozens of structures around the world that look similar and were reportedly inspired by the Eiffel Tower. The U.S. also has several, including the Eiffel Tower replica in Las Vegas. It's half the size of the real one, which is 1,083 feet tall. There's also, isn't there a small one in, like, Paris, Kentucky, and Bourbon County?
I don't know that. I automatically play out of, like, the tower at Kings Island.
Yes, yeah, yeah. I'm pretty sure there's, like, a very miniature replica of the Eiffel Tower in Paris, you know, like Paris, France, Paris, Kentucky, Bourbon County. They have kind of their own Eiffel Tower, too.
I'll have to ask the other horticulture agent.
Yes.
Who's in Bourbon County.
Who is that? Who's the Bourbon County horticulture agent? Let's give him a shout out.
Ray Tackett.
Shout out to Ray Tackett. Ray did not wake up this morning thinking his name would be on the radio, but yet here we are.
Yes.
Thank you,
here
Ray.
We are.
Number two, the first person to refer to the F word as an F bomb was a catcher on the New York Mets named Gary Carter. There's a quote from him in Newsday in 1988 where he says an umpire threw him out of the game for using that word, and he called it the F bomb.
Somebody had to be the first person. So. Yeah.
Number three, in the original He-Man cartoons in the early 1980s, He-Man couldn't use his sword as a weapon because of broadcast standard rules, and the only enemies he was allowed to destroy were robots.
Huh, I didn't know that. I never watched He-Man. It was kind of before my time.
Before your time, yeah.
You watched He-Man?
No, before my. I was born in 89, so it was before my time, too.
Yeah.
Number four, Disney originally had Aladdin set in Baghdad. But when the Gulf War broke out, they mixed the letters around, swapped a few out, and changed it to, how do you pronounce it, Agrabah? Is that what it is?
Now I can't say it. I had it in my head.
Agrabah?
Agrabah?
Yeah. So it was Baghdad, now it's Agrabah because of the Gulf War. And number five, 22% of people say the first time they figured out how to send a text message was when they were texting in their vote for American Idol.
I would believe that. Mm-hmm. I remember that.
Texting becoming a thing. Text your vote now to this number on American Idol, one of the earlier seasons, and that's when people sent their first text message.
I remember the American Idol craze. I remember watching all those first seasons and people texting there.
And we were able to watch a couple of local people on the season, 3 years ago with Alyssa Ray and Alex Miller. So.
Yep.
It's come full circle. There you go, Jessica. Appreciate you being on. We'll talk to you again Thursday, okay?
All right.
All right, Jessica. Good. Bye. Jessica Besson giving us a lesson this morning on the County Agent's Corner. Hey, we're talking with Boyle County girls soccer coach Brian Deem. And Lady Rebels got a big win over Madison Central yesterday and move on to the Elite Eight of the girls soccer state tournament. And Coach Deem joins us right after this.
Hi, this is Caraway.
And Adeline.
At Mattresses and More, next door to Ace Hardware in Danville. If you are looking for new furniture or bedding, come check us out. New merchandise arriving weekly, and we sell off the floor. We offer layaway and 12-month famous cash with approved credit. Come see our Nana for the best deal in town.
You'll be glad you did.
Thanks, girls. Aren't they so sweet? Yes, more than a mattress store. That's living room suits, dining room suits, or just a single recliner. Mattresses and More, Houstonville Road, Danville.
Local high school football and hometown radio network.
This is Gary True, voice of the Mercer County Football Titan. Listen to every game on WHBN.
This is Scott Bowen, voice of the Garrett County Golden Lions. Hear the games on Z105.
This is Joe Mathis, voice of the Danville Football Admirals. Listen to every Admiral game on AM 1230 WHIR.
This is Steve Bertram inviting you to join us for Boyle County High School Football on Z105.
All games stream live at hometownlive.net.
Republic Services of Kentucky offers a single-source solution for all of your disposal needs, servicing residential, commercial, and industrial customers with offerings that include recycling and other disposal options. You have enough to worry about on a daily basis. Leave waste disposal to Republic Services. They'll handle it from there. For a quote or to discuss services, reach out to republicservices.com or give them a call at 859-263-2000. 263-2000.
Hi, this is Caraway.
And Adeline.
At Mattresses and More, next door to Ace Hardware in Danville. If you are looking for new furniture or bedding, come check us out. New merchandise arriving weekly, and we sell off the floor. We offer layaway and 12-month famous cash with approved credit. Come see our Nana for the best deal in town.
You'll be glad you did.
Thanks, girls. Aren't they so sweet? Yes, more than a mattress store. That's living room suits, dining room suits, or just a single recliner. Mattresses and More. Houstonville Road, Danville.
Hi, my name is Carol, and I'm a student at the University of Kentucky College of Nursing. You can prevent a tragedy on the farm. Make sure your children have a safe play area that's fenced in or at least separated from traffic and work areas. Make it free of dangerous debris and give them room to run and explore. Play equipment should be age-appropriate and supervised. Although parents cannot completely kid-proof a farm, it is important to make it as safe as possible.
At Linex of Danville, we offer an undercoating that protects your vehicle against road salt and gravel, which helps prevent rust, prolong the life of your vehicle. Along with the rust inhibitor, gives your vehicle total rust protection. Call for a free quote at 859-209-4033 or stop in and see us at 935 Stanford Road in Danville.
Take advantage of spooktacular savings at Don Franklin Family of Dealerships. Choose from thousands of new and pre-owned vehicles. Plus, Don Franklin's 10-year unlimited mile powertrain coverage is available for most makes and models. Hurry into Don Franklin or DonFranklinAuto.com.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by...
It's brought to you by ADA Heating and Air. Trust ADA to be there when you need them the most. ADA is always on the way. You know, you can call them 859-519-6382. That's how you get in touch with ADA Heating and Air. Partly sunny, a high today 58, low tonight 39. Sunshine tomorrow, 70. Rain showers likely Thursday and a high of 67. It's 7:51 in the morning. It is 51 degrees. And we're talking with Boyle County Lady Rebel soccer coach Brian Dean. Good morning, Coach. How are you?
Doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing great, Coach. Doing great, especially after that big win last night. For the sixth time, the Lady Rebel soccer team has advanced, Coach, the Elite Eight. 2005, 2006, 2008, 2009, 2011, and now 2023. And, Coach, you got a couple of big goals from two Maggies on the squad. Tell us about yesterday's game, Coach.
It was a physical game, as we expected to be. We got our first goal on a set piece, and Peyton Bug put a beautiful ball into the box, and we were able to find a way to get on top of it after it kind of squirreled around a little bit. Maggie Ganan put it in early to give us the 1-0 lead for the half. So that was all about just having some guts and find a way to get the ball in the net.
Yeah, he went to the half with a 1-0 lead, Coach, and you get that second goal from Maggie Burke there in the 66th minute in the second half. Let me ask you this, Coach. How relieving is it as a soccer coach to go from a 1-goal lead to a 2-goal lead? And we know that no lead necessarily is safe until the final buzzer sounds, but you feel like almost even if your team makes a mistake, it's got to be multiple mistakes compiled on top of each other for a 2-0 lead to evaporate. I'm sure there was a sigh of relief after that second goal, right?
Well, yeah, the second goal definitely gave us an edge and allowed us to change our dynamics and what we were going to do. So, Maggie, you know, Maggie Burke just got through, and she had a tough little angle, and she just went ahead and showed the courage to take the shot, and she buried it, you know, top right corner. And once that happened, you could see that the girls knew we were close. We were close to getting to the next step, and they just continued to fight and continued to play hard, and were able to get it done and secure the win.
Nine consecutive wins for you, Coach. You've given up one goal in the last nine games. You talk about stellar defense and goalkeeping. One goal in the last nine games.
Yeah, I mean, Addison Cannon made two amazing saves last night. She's doing a fantastic job. Madison Central's leading goal scorer, Nett, had two dead balls. And from my angle, they were both in if it wasn't for Addie getting over there. And they were both up close to the crossbar. And Addie got all 5 foot six of herself up enough just to carry the ball out of bounds. And we had to lock it down on a corner. So, you know, Addie's playing fantastic. Our back line right now is playing really well. We're just jiving. And, you know, I think if we can just, you know, keep ourselves grounded and just remind ourselves, you know, everything's about whatever happens that day. I think, you know, we got a shot to go ahead and whoever we play Thursday and find a way to get a win.
Yeah, so there are two games left that have not yet been decided. One of those games is you all's opponent. It's either going to be Russell or Prestonsburg. Now, it looks like it's going to be a long drive for you all either way, Coach. Tell us about Russell and Prestonsburg. Do you know much about either one of those teams?
Yeah, Russell has they got a three-headed monster up there. They got a young lady in the middle who's going to Longwood University, Division I school. And they have another girl, two girls up top, one of which my girls have played club against. She's a sophomore. and then the other one is going to Transy. So they're strong, they're physical, they're big, they're good sized, big girls that they can know how to use their body. They got some good pace. You know, that if we play them, we'll have our hands full. And then the other one's Prestonsburg. Prestonsburg was in the Elite Eight last year. Now they did lose their leading goal scorer, Anna Burchett, but they're still finding ways to win, and they're still in the Sweet 16. So, you know, when you get to this level, you know, you're doing some things right.
Yeah, so the quarterfinal window, if I understand Mike Marcy from the Advocate Messenger correctly, is Thursday through Saturday. So would you all play that game Thursday night on a school night going to Russell or Prestonsburg, or would it be pushed back to a Friday or Saturday, or how would that work?
My understanding is the home team's discretion.
Okay.
We're up for going Thursday.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, kids go, you know, during basketball season, you know, when they go to the Sweet 16. So I don't have a problem going Thursday, to be honest with you. I just prefer to go ahead and go Thursday and get it over with and go play instead of having to wait all weekend and to drive up on a Saturday morning.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, go ahead. Let's go and play, right? You don't care what day, what time, what field. Let's play soccer and see if we can advance to the Final Four.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
that's the way we train.
So that game will be, again, either Thursday, Friday, or Saturday, possibly Thursday night, and that game will be at either Russell or Prestonsburg in the Elite Eight for a chance to go to the Final Four. Coach, we're excited for you. What a big win last night, 2-0 over Madison Central, and we got to keep the good vibes going, so we'll get you on Thursday morning at 9:10, where we'll talk about, we'll know now tonight who you're going to play, but talk in depth more about that team on Thursday morning, okay?
Excellent. I appreciate you.
Yes, sir, Coach. Appreciate that. And good luck with practice. We'll talk to you Thursday, okay?
Absolutely.
Yes,
Rebels forever.
There you go. Boyle County Lady Rebel soccer coach Brian Deem has his team in the Elite Eight. According to Mike Marcy with the Advocate Messenger, Boyle County Lady Rebel soccer has never advanced to the Final Four, which, I mean, that's hard to do, right? Like, you're one of the four teams remaining in the state. So a chance to do something for the first time in school history. More than likely Thursday night, but again, I would assume it's not going to be Friday, but Thursday or Saturday, more than likely Thursday night, where you have Boyle County either Boyle County either at Russell or at Prestonsburg. And to look forward to that game and talking with Coach Deem about that on Thursday morning. Right now it's 7:57. We are 2.5 minutes away from Top Hour News right here in the Joe Show on 103.9 FM WHIR Danville.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Hey, good morning. You're heading to the airport, right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now. I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code TAXI for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code TAXI for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code TAXI.
The new home for A&L Accessories in Danville is at 491 South 4th Street next to Smart Loop. Featuring gifts, purses, jewelry, watches, scarves, body care products, and official Simply Southern Products dealer. Open 11:30 Tuesday through Saturday. Stop in the new home for A&L Accessories in Danville, 493 South 4th.
Talk Kentucky Sports, weekday mornings at 10 with Matt Jones and Kentucky Sports Radio, right here on AM 1230 WHIR.
It's Halloween, and you're afraid some brat's going to soap your windows or teepee your house. Worry no more with Halloweenium, the Halloween formula tranquilizer. Taken as directed, Halloweenium can soothe jangled nerves caused by kids too old to be trick-or-treating, joyriding around your neighborhood. And if you take Halloweenium with vodka, which is not as directed, but trust me, it helps, you might not wake up until Thanksgiving. And by then, the toilet paper, soaped windows, and broken pumpkins will have been cleaned up by somebody else. Ask your doctor about Halloweenium, and then ask him about Thanksgiving zine and Christmas at all. Because with your family, you're going to want those, too.
All right, coming up at the 8 o'clock hour. We have Boyle County Public Library Director Colleen Hall at 8:10. No Randyisms today. Randy Graham is off today. And so we hope to get Randy back in studio Thursday, but no Randyisms today at 8:20. 8:40, James the Gardener, 9 o'clock hour. Dusty at 9:10, the Kentucky Music Preview. And at 9:35, Ann Yeager or Mary Stith Hamlin with Stith Funeral Home. And a talk of a lifetime. We're halfway home on the Joe Show. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. Here's Top Hour News on 103.9 FM WHIR.
This is the talk of the town, AM 1230, and now on FM 103.9, WHIR Danville, powered by Kentucky WiMAX.
It's 8 o'clock.
NBC News Radio, I'm Michael Kastner. President Biden is taking a trip to Israel. Brian Shook with more.
Secretary of State Antony Blinken said Monday during a briefing after meeting with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu that the president will make the trip on Wednesday. Biden's expected to meet with Netanyahu and other Israeli leaders. He was invited to Egypt for an international summit on Saturday that focuses on the future of Palestinians, but it's unclear if he would make any additional stops. I'm Brian Shook.
The United States and Israel are working to provide humanitarian aid to Gaza. Secretary of State Antony Blinken made the announcement during his latest trip to Israel as fighting continues with the Palestinian militant group Hamas.
The United States and Israel have agreed to develop a plan that will enable humanitarian aid from donor nations and multilateral organizations to reach civilians in Gaza and them alone, including the possibility of creating areas to help keep civilians out of harm's way.
Blinken called it critical that aid begins arriving soon into Gaza. The news comes following the announcement that the president will be in Israel on Wednesday. A vote for the new Speaker of the House is expected today. House Democratic Whip Catherine Clark confirms the vote on Representative Jim Jordan will happen, but it's still unclear if Jordan will gather enough votes to secure the position. While the GOP holds a slight majority in the House, only 4 votes can be sacrificed to win, with some Republicans expressing concern about Jordan. Ford's chairman is urging the United Auto Workers to make a deal and end its month-long strike. Mark Mayfield with details.
On Monday, Bill Ford warned the ongoing strike by UAW threatens the future of his company and the American automotive industry. Last week, more than 8,000 workers walked off the job at the Ford plant in Louisville, Kentucky.
Michael Kastner, NBC News Radio.
Kentucky is a special place. I see it everywhere I go. I'm Andy Beshear. We've been through a lot these past 4 years, but Kentuckians are the hardest working, most resilient people I know. We faced down impossible challenges, and we've come out stronger on the other side. I will always show up for Kentucky families because we look out for each other. We're rebuilding homes and whole new neighborhoods from natural disasters because we have a responsibility to our fellow Kentuckian. We're growing our economy at a record pace, creating thousands of new, good-paying jobs. Unemployment has never been lower. And we've cut the income tax by 10% in a fiscally responsible way. There's still work to do. That's why my education plan includes well-deserved and necessary raises for our public school teachers. We've turned the corner, and we're moving forward. Let's keep it going. I'm Andy Beshear, and I approve this message. Paid for by Andy Beshear for Governor.
Former President Donald Trump is expected back in court in Lower Manhattan today for his civil fraud trial. Scott Pringle reports.
Well, Trump is expected to witness firsthand testimony from his accountant and real estate executives who appraised his properties. Trump previously drew huge crowds of reporters and some protesters when he attended the first 3 days of his $250 million civil fraud trial, holding press conferences in the court hallway. The New York State Attorney General is accusing Trump of inflating his net worth for years in order to obtain more favorable loans. Trump has called this case a political witch hunt.
New Jersey Senator Bob Menendez claims the feds are hunting him down like prey. His strong reaction comes after a new criminal charge that he allegedly conspired to act as an agent for the government of Egypt in exchange for cash and gold bars.
So the bottom line is this: the government is engaged in primitive hunting. That's where you continue to hound your prey until it's exhausted, and then you kill it. That's not going to work with me.
Menendez says he's not going to resign. Meantime, the senator is due back in federal court next week, where he's expected to plead not guilty to the added criminal count. Fall brings cooler temperatures and tailgate season. Breed Tennis with more.
According to a study by Quicken Loans, 80% of all Americans tailgate at least once a year. Most do it five times. And it's big business, with people dropping $35 billion in food and beverages nationwide each season. All Recipe says in California, it's not a tailgate without guacamole. In Colorado, it's beef ribs. And in Wisconsin, it's all about the bratwurst.
Taco Bell has the shortest wait for a fast food drive-thru, according to a new study. QRS Magazine is out with their annual drive-thru report, which found Taco Bell drive-thru customers wait an average of about 4 minutes. Chick-fil-A has the longest average wait at around 7 minutes. Michael Kastner, NBC News.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cartown Kia.
It's your choice, the new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cartown Kia and CartownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 due at signing, 2023 Kia Sorento, $2,556 due at signing, $349 down, $349 per month, 36-month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, dock, and acquisition fees with approved credit. No security deposit required. All incentives to dealer price may not include dealer added options. See dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st, 2023.
For most of us, power outages, however rare, are a frustrating inconvenience. For others, they're a matter of life and death. If you or someone you love depends on electrically powered life support equipment, give the friendly folks at your local electric cooperative a call. They can help by noting the situation on a special list of customers who receive top priority in restoring power following unplanned outages. We're Kentucky's electric cooperative, and our power is our people.
Inter County Energy, a Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
The Hometown Radio Network sports broadcast schedule brought to you by Monticello Bank. High school football Friday night. Danville host Breathitt County on 103.9 FM WHIR. Boyle County host Wayne County on Z105. And Mercer County is at Garrett County. The Garrett broadcast on hometownlive.net. The Mercer broadcast on 99.5 FM WHBN. All of those games kick off at 7:30. Meanwhile, on Saturday, the Cats are on bye this week. They take on Tennessee the following week at Kroger Field. Good morning to you. It is Tuesday. It's October the 17th, 51 degrees right here in Danville. We get up into the mid-50s as a high today, maybe upper 50s, 58 degrees, 59 or so. Forecast is coming your way. We talk with Colleen from the Boyle County Public Library after this as well. Here's local news.
This is a Hometown Radio Network information update.
Ephraim McDowell Health is now helping fight food insecurity with the Ephraim McDowell Food Assistance Partnership Program. The program provides individual boxes of non-perishable food for food insecure patients and their families upon discharge from any of Ephraim's three hospitals, Ephraim McDowell Regional Medical Center in Danville, Fort Logan Hospital in Stanford, and Hagen Hospital in Harrodsburg. The food boxes include shelf-stable meal items that are easy to cook and is intended to feed a patient and their family for up to 2 days. Families can participate in the Food Assistance Partnership based on their responses to a survey they take when they're admitted to the hospital. It's Frank X. Walker Creative Arts Festival Week at the Danville School System this week. The event started yesterday and continued today with a Frank X. Walker Artist Talk for the middle and high school students. Tomorrow with the Frank X. Walker readings at Hogsett and Tolliver. And then Thursday and Friday with the creative art workshops in the schools. There will also be an opening reception and a Frank X. Walker visual art exhibit beginning today and going through October 28th. Frank X. Walker is a Danville High School graduate who was appointed Poet Laureate of Kentucky in 2013, the first African-American to hold that position. And two school resource officers will have their own SRO vehicles thanks to a donation to Lincoln County Schools. The Ohio County Sheriff's Office recently donated 2 used police cars to Lincoln County Schools and the Stanford Police Department. Lincoln Schools says the vehicles will be used for their school resource officers. The first phase of repairs to the Anderson Dean Park pool have been approved. The Harrodsburg Herald reports that at their last park board meeting, the board of directors approved a $175,400 bid from American Leak Detection of Mount Washington for phase one of those pool repairs. The Anderson Dean Park pool had been closed since June after officials learned the pool had leaked 1 million gallons of water in its first week it was open. And remember, today is the pop-up driver's licensing program in Lincoln County. Last year, the state changed where you get your licenses and renew them by making regional driver's license offices. However, it's still inconvenient for some to get to those other counties. So to make it easier, they're hosting pop-up programs. In our area, Lincoln County will host a pop-up driver's license program today at the Lincoln County Public Library. Meanwhile, Mercer County will have theirs on Thursday at the Mercer County Courthouse. You can register online at the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet website drive.ky.gov. I'm Joe Mathis.
Listen to WHIR online at hometownlive.net, powered by Kentucky, WiMAX.com.
The decisions at breakfast are tough, but Wendy's makes it a little bit easier with their 2 for $3 biggie bundles. And what we mean by this is you pick any 2 of these items, you get it for $3. The small seasoned potatoes they have, their breakfast side, sausage biscuit, egg and cheese biscuit, and a medium hot coffee. Any 2 of those, you get them for $3. You can have a sausage biscuit or an egg cheese biscuit. You can have 2 sausage biscuits. You can have 2 seasoned potatoes. You can have a seasoned potatoes and a coffee. You can have a coffee and an egg cheese biscuit. Whatever you want, any combination, 2 of those for $3. The choice is all yours. And you can also add the brand new Frosty Cream Cold Brew to your order. Available in vanilla, caramel, and chocolate. Their new Frosty Cream Cold Brew is a morning maker, puts other post-lunch pick-me-ups down, and makes for a tasty late-night drink. It's available all day at Wendy's, not just a breakfast item. It's an all-day thing. The 2 for $3 biggie bundles and the Frosty Cream Cold Brew at Wendy's in Danville. Tell them you heard it this morning on The Joe Show.
This Joe Show weather report brought to you by
Coel Collision Center in Danville. They're on Lebanon Road. After a wreck, tell the tow truck driver take your vehicle to the experts, Brent and Devin, at Coel Collision Center, Lebanon Road, right here in Danville. Partly sunny skies, a high today 58, low tonight 39, sunshine tomorrow and 70. Thursday showers likely, mostly cloudy, high of 67. It's 8:11 in the morning. It is 51 degrees in Danville. Tuesday, October 17th. That's 101723 on your calendar. And on Tuesday mornings at this time, we talk with the Boyle County Public Library. Colleen joins us this morning. Good morning, Colleen. How are you?
I'm well. Good morning, Joe. How are you?
I'm doing great. Appreciate you being on here, Colleen. What do we got going on this week at the Boyle County Public Library?
Well, I was really glad you mentioned the Frank X. Walker Creative Festival that's happening.
Yeah.
Because the library has an exhibit of Frank's art to coordinate with that festival, and there is an opening reception for him tonight at 5:30 at the library.
Awesome.
So if people are interested in coming to see his artwork, visual art now, not writing, he had a whole collection of new works that got put up yesterday. So if people are interested, come on down for the reception or any time. I believe it'll be up until the 28th.
Awesome. Good stuff. Love to hear that. Yeah, Frank X. Walker, what a kind of a great thing to have him come back and be involved in the local schools as a local graduate from Danville Schools, Danville High School, Kentucky Poet Laureate, and to have him come back and be able to talk with the students and read some of his works and, as you said, some of his visual artworks on display at the library. That's an awesome thing to be able to do every year.
Yes, and he's a wonderful library supporter, so we're just really glad we can display his work.
Good stuff. What else is going on, Colleen?
Well, tonight we also have Tranquility Tuesdays, which is a program for adults. It's a monthly mindfulness program, and that'll be happening from 6 to 7 p.m. tonight.
Okay.
Wednesday, tomorrow at 4 p.m., there's a kids program, Creepy Cartoons. There will be scary, not really super scary cartoons going on in the children's area at 4 p.m., so come on down and watch and celebrate spooky season with us. And then on Friday, we have one of our special October programs. It's a Monster Bash at 4:30. They'll be dancing with the Out There Creative Arts and Dance Studio. There'll be face painting. There'll be crafts and activities. So please come down. That's a family activity. Please come on down at 4:30 on Friday.
Okay.
And then on Saturday, we have a bonfire at the library from 5 to 8. There'll be marshmallow roasting and cider and spooky stories that'll be shared by local writers who participated in one of our writing fall flash fiction workshops. They're going to be telling their stories at the bonfire.
Awesome stuff. So, I mean, you've got, like, all kinds of great fall activities going on then, right? Like, scary, spooky stuff, but not too scary where kids can't be involved. You got bonfires going on. You got all kinds of, I mean, when you think of fall, those are the things you think of, being outside around a bonfire, you know, Halloween. And so, good stuff coming up at the library then.
Yeah, those are just the highlights. Of course, there's a lot more on our website, which is boylepublib.org, mm-hmm. or you can call us 238-7323. That's 238-READ.
238-READ. Also, Facebook, Boyle County Public Library. They do a great job of updating their page on Facebook and all their activities that are coming up there as well. Colleen, appreciate you being on. You have a great week, and we'll talk to you again next Tuesday, okay?
I have a question, Joe.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
What's going on with the candy bracket?
I'm glad you asked that question because it had just slipped my mind. And so I'm glad we got to have you vote. I was getting ready to hang up and end the conversation. Colleen, I'm glad you said that. So let's do it. We have made it to the Sweet 16.
Okay.
There are two candies that have advanced to the Elite 8. We had a couple of matchups, a couple of games yesterday. Snickers topped 100 grand in easy fashion, 5-0, which means Snickers over Laffy Taffy in the first round, Snickers over 100 grand in the second round. They've outscored their opponent candies now 10-1. So Snickers is rolling in this candy bracket. And then yesterday, M&M's also topped Twizzlers. So in that Elite Eight, it'll be Snickers versus M&M's. But we're going to have you this morning vote on the bottom left quadrant of matchups today. That's the one we're working on today. So here we go. The number two overall seed, Twix, which easily beat Airheads 5-0, takes on the seventh seeded Starburst, which beat Candy Corn in the first round. Twix or Starburst? What do you have, Colleen?
Twix, 100%.
Twix, 100%, takes a 2-1 lead over Starburst. Early lead for Twix. The other matchup, Colleen, Three Musketeers, which got to the Sweet 16 by beating Nestle Crunch in the first round. They're the 11 seed. They take on the 3-seeded Classic Chocolate Hershey Bars. Which one are you going with?
Oh, that's hard. I'm going to go for Hershey's.
Hershey's taking a 3-0 lead over Three Musketeers. So, Colleen, that's what we have. We're working our way through the bracket. I forgot to ask my boss to post it on social media, so maybe I'll remember this week to do that so we can have our people on Facebook take a look at what's going on as well and keep up with the matchups. So,
sounds great.
Good stuff. Colleen, thanks for being on, and we'll talk to you later, okay?
Sounds great. Thanks, Joe.
Bye. That's Colleen Hall with the Boyle County Public Library. She's the new executive director of the library and does a great job there. And what a fun spot the library is with all the great events, activities they have from preschool-aged babies, preschool-aged, all the way up to adults. They've always got something going on there at the library, so check it out. And again, their Facebook page, Boyle County Public Library on Facebook, to keep up to date what's going on there. Let's see what's going on in this morning's Sort of Sports Report. Starting off with Major League Baseball yesterday, where the early game saw the Rangers and Astros take on each other head-to-head. The Rangers in the driver's seat now in the best-of-seven series, going up 2-0 with a 5-4 win. Texas put up 4 runs in the first and never looked back, though it did get dramatic in the fifth when Nathan Eovaldi had to dig deep to get out of a bases-loaded jam with nobody out. But the Rangers beat the Astros yesterday 5-4.
Game two. Fly ball, center field. Tavares comes on. The call, the catch, the win in game two. A nail-biter that goes Texas way. 5-4, and they lead this best of seven. 2-0.
Meanwhile, things were raucous as always in Philadelphia, where the Phillies opened the series making a serious statement, treating their home crowd to a 2 first-inning home run blast from Kyle Schwarber, and then a couple of batters later, Bryce Harper, and a second-inning home run from former Red who wanted to stay in Cincinnati, Nick Castellanos, his 5th home run in the last 3 games, and then a 4th run in the 3rd inning. The Diamondbacks were able to play a few to make a game out of it, but Philadelphia held on to a 5-3 win.
Drives out on the right. Got some heat on it. And this is going to be up and out of here. Castellanos. He's on a home run binge.
Yeah, tonight we'll see game two of that Arizona-Philly series. First pitch at 8:07 and can be seen on TBS and on Max. What else is going on in sports? Starting off with college basketball, where the 2023-24 NCAA men's basketball regular season begins on November 7th. And yesterday, the first AP Top 25 poll was released. Sees Kansas as the undisputed number one team in the country with 46 of 63 first-place votes going their way. The top 10 ranks like this: Kansas 1, Duke 2, Purdue 3, Michigan State 4, Marquette 5, UConn 6, Houston 7, Creighton at 8, Tennessee at 9, FAU at 10. Kentucky, by the way, comes in at number 16. It is the lowest preseason ranking for Kentucky in the John Calipari era, but that's okay. We worry more about postseason rankings, and well, those haven't gone UK's way recently either, but hopefully they do this year. In the NFL, the New York Jets had a little help from the sidelines and Aaron Rodgers as they managed to take down the undefeated Eagles on Sunday. Sources say Rodgers was under the headset the whole game and was an active voice giving suggestions to the Jets coaching staff, even passing along play suggestions to the coach. And in the NFL, the Antonio Brown clown car is rolling again. Yesterday, Brown was arrested by the Broward County Sheriff's Office for allegedly not paying child support. Brown has since been released on a bond of $15,000. Wiltress Jackson is the mother of Brown's daughter, Antonia. Jackson told TMZ that Brown is in to the tune of almost $31,000 in unpaid child support, and no bones about the fact that she wanted her baby daddy behind bars if he didn't start paying up. That's what's going on in the Sort of Sports Report this morning.
Hello, Central Kentucky. I'm Steve Bertram with sports. Last night in the opening round of the girls' state high school soccer tournament, 12th region champ Boyle County defeated 11th region champ Madison Central 2-0 at Rebel Stadium. The Lady Rebels now advance to the Elite Eight Thursday night. Boyle has posted shutouts in 5 of its 6 postseason games. There were 2 games in baseball's league championship series Monday. In the ALCS, Texas jumped out to a 5-1 lead, then held off Houston for a 5-3 win and a 2-0 lead in the series. Game 3 is in Arlington tomorrow night. In Game 1 of the NLCS, Philadelphia jumped out on top of Arizona 5-0, then held off the Diamondbacks to win Game 1 5-3. Game 2 starters tonight, Aaron Nola for the Phillies against Merrill Kelly for the Diamondbacks. In the NFL Monday night special, Dallas defeated the LA Chargers 20-17. Cowboys improved 4-2, while the Chargers dropped to 2-3. Georgia remains number 1 in the AP College Football Top 25 this week. Louisville fell to 21st, and Kentucky dropped out. The Bulldogs are followed in the top 5 by Michigan, Ohio State, Florida State, and Oklahoma. Other SEC schools ranked this week are Alabama at number 11, Ole Miss 13th, Tennessee 17th, LSU 19th, and Missouri is 20th. Kentucky has an open date this week and will host number 17 Tennessee on October 28th. Boyle County shortstop Cam Owens has committed to playing baseball at the University of Kentucky. Owens, a rising senior in a class of 24, hit .481 last year with 9 homers and 40 ribbies. We'll have the Kentucky men's basketball blue-white scrimmage on the air this Saturday from Northern Kentucky University. Pre-game show start at 5:30. Tip-off is at 6 on Z105. All proceeds from the game go to Eastern Kentucky Flood Relief and Western Kentucky Tornado Relief. That's sports. God bless America. I'm Steve Bertram on the Hometown Radio Network.
Lee's Famous Recipe of Danville is honored to have served this community since 1972. They're excited to announce they are offering even more $5.99 lunch specials. Choose from Lee's two-piece breast strip, two-piece dark chicken slider, or a barbecue chicken sandwich. All specials come with a side of your choice along with a regular drink and an apple pie or cookie. Wednesday's Customer Appreciation Day. Come on in and ask for the Wednesday special. Three pieces of Famous Crispy or strips, two sides of your choice. Hot homestyle buttermilk biscuit, all a dollar off the regular price. Don't feel like cooking tonight? Try one of their family meals. They come in options of 8, 12, 16, or 20-piece selections with your choice of sides. They specialize in catering, so if you need to cater a wedding, office party, funeral, birthday party, or any other special event, call them at 859-236-8777, 236-8777 for a free quote. Let them do all the work for you. They're located at 610 South 4th Street. Drive through or come on in. Lee's Famous Recipe, serving the best chicken in Danville for over 40 years.
Loading the kids in the car, brokering peace in the back seat, mastering the snack handoff without even looking. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with auto owners, insurance doesn't have to be one of them. We work with independent agents who keep insurance simple, so you can worry about more important things, like figuring out what's growing in that cup holder. That's simple human sense.
Ask Dexter and Reitmeyer Insurance Agency in Danville if auto owners make sense for you. Call me, Mark Dexter, or Chris Reitmeyer.
Local high school football at Hometown Radio Network.
This is Gary True, voice of the Mercer County Football Titan. Listen to every game on WHBN.
This is Scott Bowen, voice of the Garrett County Golden Lions. Hear the games on Z105.
This is Joe Mampus, voice of the Danville Football Admirals. Listen to every Admiral game on AM 1230 WHIR.
This is Steve Bertram inviting you to join us for Boyle County High School Football on Z105.
All games stream live at hometownlive.net.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by
Coel Collision Center in Danville. They're on Lebanon Road. After wreck, tell the tow truck driver you can take your vehicle to the experts, Brent and Devin, at Coel Collision Center, Lebanon Road in Danville. Sunshine, 58 high, 39 low. Tomorrow, 70 and 51. Thursday, 67. Rain showers Thursday. Football Friday, mostly cloudy, high is 62. So close, yet so far away to another Football Friday. Right now, it's 8:25 in the morning. It is 51 degrees in Danville today. I've been told it's Danville Band Day at Lee's Famous Recipe right here in Danville. And all the, or not all the proceeds, but a portion of the proceeds, because, I mean, Lee's has got to make money too, but a portion of the proceeds goes to benefit the Danville Band from 4 until close today. So this is always a big day. Get out, support the Danville Band, eating at Lee's Famous Recipe in Danville. A portion of the proceeds go to benefit the Danville Band. That's today from 4 o'clock until close. And then the Boyle Band Day, I'm sure, will be coming up in the near future as well. But today, Danville Band Day, 4 until close. Go support the Admiral Band by eating Lee's Famous Recipe. Speaking of Lee's, they'll be on the show a week from tomorrow. Next Wednesday, the 25th, we'll have Justin Newton back on the show talking Lee's. And they do such a good job supporting the community, so make sure you get out there and support Lee's and the Danville Band today with Danville Band Day from 4 until close. Let's see what's going on this date, October 17th. That's made this date a date to remember. Starting off on this date back in 1931, where Al Capone was fined $50,000, sentenced to 11 years in prison for tax evasion. He was paroled after 8 years and went to live in Miami, where he died almost 10 years later, though he was never convicted of it. He was suspected of killing over 500 people during his reign of terror in Chicago. Here's a clip of a historian talking about how the federal agents caught Capone.
federal agents have a breakthrough, realizing that mobsters make public displays of their wealth without filing any income taxes. IRS agent Frank Wilson takes the case, poring over confiscated ledgers to find a way to trace the money from illegal activities back to Capone.
Yeah, on this day, 1933, Albert Einstein arrived in the U.S. as a refugee from Nazi Germany. Here's a clip of a California official welcoming Einstein to California.
Professor and Mrs. Einstein, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the city of San Diego and to the state of California.
Yeah, that's the original audio of a California official welcoming Einstein to California. It was on this day, 1996, the Atlanta Braves had the biggest blowout in the history of the postseason, trouncing the St. Louis Cardinals 15-0 in Game 7 of the National League Championship Series to complete a comeback from a 3-1 deficit. The Cardinals became the only club to blow a 3-1 edge three times in the postseason. The Braves beat the Cardinals 15-0. They would lose the World Series, though, that year to the New York Yankees.
In the center. Here comes Atlanta, New York.
Yeah, it was on this day, 2005. Stephen Colbert's show, The Colbert Report, premiered on Comedy Central on this date. 2005. I'm not a huge Stephen Colbert fan myself. This is his theme song, though. On this day, 2012, Lance Armstrong lost his just about all of his endorsements in the wake of a doping scandal. Here's a clip of Lance Armstrong admitting that he did take dope in an interview with Oprah.
Yes or no? Did you ever take banned substances to enhance your cycling performance?
Yes.
Yes or no? Was one of those banned substances EPO?
Yes.
And it was on this day, 2019, Mickey Mulvaney, then President Trump's acting chief of staff, said the White House withheld nearly $400 million in military aid from Ukraine to further Trump's own political interest. He later denied ever saying that. Here's a clip of his comments in 2019.
We do that all the time with foreign policy. I have news for everybody. Get over it. There's going to be political influence in foreign policy.
And that's what's gone on this date, October 17th. That's made this date a date to remember. 8:29 in the morning, a minute away from our bottom hour news with the Kentucky News Network. James the Gardener's in studio. We'll talk with James in about 15 minutes right here on The Joe Show, giving us a gardening tip on this cloudy and chilly Tuesday.
The Parthenon Greek American Eats.
Hi, this is Jimmy, letting you know about some of our seafood options, including grilled salmon, grilled tilapia, grilled shrimp, or you could do a combo with grilled tilapia and shrimp, fried jumbo shrimp, hand-battered cod, our delicious hand-battered cod sandwich with fresh French fries. As always, we only use fresh ingredients made to order. That's at the Parthenon Greek American Eats in Danville in the Greenleaf Shopping Center.
Dine in or take out, fresh from our family.
If you're feeling hopeless, alone, and broken, maybe empty inside, Chloe's Petals for Hope.
Chloe's Petals for Hope sponsors a survivor of suicide support group for adults the first Thursday of every month at the Boyle County Library Community Room from 6 to 7 p.m. Follow us on Facebook and look at our website, Chloe's Petals for Hope, for more information.
Because it's just around the corner, we'll find hope together. Chloe's Petals for Hope.
For help, call the crisis hotline, 988.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Northern Kentucky University, the host of last night's gubernatorial debate, incumbent Democratic Governor Andy Beshear and Republican challenger Daniel Cameron, the current Kentucky Secretary of State, using the time to verbally spar a bit as the election nears. One of the discussion points, the UAW strike and the effect of Louisville's Ford Kentucky truck plant walking out. The challenger, Cameron.
Wages need to be increased. These workers know that, but they are having to deal with the challenge of more expensive groceries, more expensive gas, and more expensive childcare. What I think is incredibly important is that you have a governor that eliminates the income tax to make sure that these folks have more money in their pocket to pay for those things that I just talked about, and also, again, increase their wages at the plant. I support the workers and will make sure that they have leadership in the governor's office that works for them.
And Governor Beshear's response.
What we have to have here is a win-win. win. Our UAW families are fighting for better wages and better health care benefits, something we should want for every single one of our citizens. We need them to come out of this, being able to provide more opportunity for their kids, a better future here in Kentucky. But we also need a strong Ford coming out of it. They invested $5.8 billion in our Commonwealth. We're building the two biggest battery plants on planet Earth.
Audio courtesy WCPO-TV. King of Kentucky Bourbon is returning for its sixth annual release. Brown-Forman announcing the limited edition expression is a 16-year-old Kentucky straight bourbon. Only 3,800 bottles will be available at a price of $300 each. I'm Sean McCormick.
This is the Kentucky News Network.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Hey, good morning. You're heading to the airport, right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now, but I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code TAXI for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code TAXI for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code TAXI.
Hello, Central Kentucky. My name is Alan Martin, loan officer at Whitaker Bank. As a lifelong Danville native, I'm excited to be able to help neighbors like yourself find financial options to fit your family. If you'd like to see what we can do for you, give me a call today at 859-236-9822. That's 859-236-9822. Or even better, stop in and see me at 218 West Main here in downtown Danville. Whitaker Bank is uniquely Kentucky, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
This is a Hometown Radio Network information update. Ephraim McDowell Health is now helping fight food insecurity with the Ephraim McDowell Food Assistance Partnership Program. The program provides individual boxes of non-perishable food for food insecure patients and their families upon discharge from any of Ephraim's three hospitals, Ephraim McDowell Regional Medical Center in Danville, Fort Logan Hospital in Stanford, and Hagen Hospital in Harrodsburg. The food boxes include shelf-stable meal items that are easy to cook and is intended to feed a patient and their family for up to 2 days. Families can participate in the Food Assistance Partnership based on their responses to a survey they take when they're admitted to the hospital. It's Frank X. Walker Creative Arts Festival Week at the Danville School System this week. The event started yesterday and continued today with a Frank X. Walker Artist Talk for the middle and high school students. Tomorrow with the Frank X. Walker readings at Hogsett and Tolliver. And then Thursday and Friday with the creative art workshops in the schools. There will also be an opening reception and a Frank X. Walker visual art exhibit beginning today and going through October 28th. Frank X. Walker is a Danville High School graduate who was appointed Poet Laureate of Kentucky in 2013, the first African-American to hold that position. And two school resource officers will have their own SRO vehicles thanks to a donation to Lincoln County Schools. The Ohio County Sheriff's Office recently donated two used police cars to Lincoln County Schools and the Stanford Police Department. Lincoln Schools says the vehicles will be used for their school resource officers. The first phase of repairs to the Anderson Dean Park pool have been approved. The Harrodsburg Herald reports that at their last park board meeting, the board of directors approved a $175,400 bid from American Leak Detection of Mount Washington for phase one of those pool repairs. The Anderson Dean Park pool had been closed since June after officials learned the pool had leaked 1 million gallons of water in its first week it was open. And remember, today is the pop-up driver's licensing program in Lincoln County. Last year, the state changed where you get your licenses and renew them by making regional driver's license offices. However, it's still inconvenient for some to get to those other counties. So to make it easier, they're hosting pop-up programs. In our area, Lincoln County will host a pop-up driver's license program today at the Lincoln County Public Library. Meanwhile, Mercer County will have theirs on Thursday at the Mercer County Courthouse. You can register online at the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet website drive.ky.gov. I'm Joe Mathis.
Hey, Joe, did you know Big Deals has got something new?
Where can I save money now, Radio Rick?
We've got the Anderson Lifestyle Boutique in Danville. Buy a $50 gift certificate for a Big Deals price of just $35.
Sounds awesome. What do they have?
They offer jewelry, apparel, gifts, and home decor. They do embroidery and monogramming. Come and see their selection of comfortable jeans, heavy canvas bags, lamps, art, scratch-made soap scents, natural soy candles. Find the perfect curtains, blinds, and shutters for your home.
Sounds great. I know where I can get my wife a gift and save money. Please don't tell her.
It's up to me. Joe, you like to eat, don't you?
You bet.
Save money at the Big City Pizza Company in Danville. Another new way to save.
I'd love to have some of their three cheese mac and cheese pizza.
Well, get over to hometownlive.net and save on Big City Pizza with a $10 gift certificate for just $7.
I'm on it. Pizza night tonight at the Memphis House.
You, too, can save with more big deals at hometownlive.net. Lots of discounts like Bread of Life, Sweets by Cindy, O'Charlie's, Applebee's, the old bus station, and A&L accessories.
When it comes to pizza, I'm a little particular. Yeah, I like a vintage homemade toast dough and sauce. Plenty of toppings, like a cheesy top and a light crunch on the bottom. I want a New York taste or sometimes that deep dish Chicago style. Say what? Big City Pizza Company. They make award-winning pizzas, sandwiches, desserts, plus a great place for pizza parties with the Big Bambino, Oval, a two-foot pizza. Order for your flavor now at BigCityPizzaKY.com.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by...
Brought to you by Cattleman's Roadhouse. Whether steaks are aged 28 days, they're hand-cut and second to none in tenderness and in flavor. Cattleman's Roadhouse, Danville Bypass. A great steak truly is just the beginning. Partly sunny, 58, 39. The high and low, sunshine tomorrow, 70. Sunshine into Thursday, and then clouds take over Thursday afternoon, 67 the high, and some rain showers in the forecast on Thursday. Mostly cloudy on Football Friday. Right now it's 8:38, 50 degrees in Danville. Wedding Planning with Pim. What do you got for us, Pimmy?
Hi, I'm Pim Pfister-Clark, and this is Wedding Planning with Pim. Dancing comes naturally to some men. To others, not so much. No matter the level of your proficiency, at your wedding, you'll be expected to dance, and everyone will be watching. No one expects you to dance like a pro, but you don't want to make a spectacle of yourself either. So here are some basic tips for getting through the night easily. First, turn on some music. You need to get a feel for the balance of your body and how music affects your rhythm. Stand straight with your feet together, toes pointing forward. Hold your head high and keep your shoulders down and relaxed. Listen to the music and gently bounce your knees in place to the rhythm of the music. Next, raise and lower your heels to the rhythm. Assume the holding position. Raise your arms, bending your right arm at the elbow so your right hand is facing slightly above the center of your waistline. Bend your left elbow and raise it to a position about level with your head. Hold your partner's hand and grasp her around the waist. When you feel comfortable, try a basic stride. Put your feet together with your weight on your left foot. Move your right foot forward as you shift your weight forward. Evenly balance your weight and move the left foot out to the side and release the right heel. There are library books that can help you with this. My love note, you've heard it, practice makes perfect.
Your small business is always top of mind. Well, top of your mind. To get it to the top of other people's minds, you need to get your name out front, which is where Staples Print and Marketing Services can put it. A yard sign over there, brochures right here, a banner up there. In fact, your business's message could appear anywhere. And right now at Staples, get $100 off your print purchase of $250 or more. Make a splash with your small business print and marketing materials at Staples. Ends 11/4. Visit staples.com/print for details.
I've been taking Nutrafol for about a year.
I've been taking Nutrafol for just over 4.5 years.
My hair was thinning.
I just gave birth. I was under a lot of stress.
I like Nutrafol because it's drug-free and the number one dermatologist recommended hair growth supplement.
My hair feels thicker.
Stronger.
The breakage is less.
Nutrafol has taken me back to the hair I was meant to have.
Join the 1 million people growing at Nutrafol.com.
That's NUTRAFOL.com.
Did you know that WHIR AM 1230 is the talk of the town? We're not spreading gossip. We're just letting you know where the best talk radio is found all day, every day. Mornings begin with Danville's own Joe Mathis and The Joe Show.
Hey, this is Joe Mathis.
Wake up to what you missed. News, weather, sports, and local guests. Followed by Kentucky Sports Radio with Matt Jones.
Welcome, everyone. Kentucky Sports Radio. I'm Matt Jones.
Then, the man who has an opinion about everything, Tomas Mauricio.
I'm Tomas Mauricio. I invite you to tune in.
Starting at noon with Advocates for America.
Then at 3,
it's the best-known name in news, Sean Hannity.
Join me, Sean Hannity, on WHIR.
Then, Joe Pag starts off weekday evenings at 6 with his take on the day's news, mixed with his fun parody songs about the news.
Hey, it's Joe Pag on WHIR.
Afterwards, at 10, it's the unique world of John B. Wells on WHIR with his Caravan to Midnight show.
This is John B. Wells, WHIR, AM 1230 and FM 103.9.
These guys have a lot to say, and they'll be glad to have you join them every weekday on your home for news, talk, sports. AM 1230, WHIR, the talk of the town.
And now, for the next few minutes, the man with the jolly green bum and the big
shot. Oh, sorry about that, James. No, James is not in here yet. I didn't mean that. That's operator error. I did not mean to play that, and I clicked the wrong thing. However,
catch the best of Sean Hannity, Saturday mornings, 10 to 1, on WHIR.
There we go. Let's get this train back on the track, so to say. All right, we got Grub Gab, the world of food. Going to have that coming up in just a second. Speaking of food, a Grubhub driver was caught on video eating mouthfuls of a customer's food. I've had friends have that happen to them before where they ordered Grubhub and they got like a message from their Grubhub driver that said, hey, sorry, I was hungry and I ate your food. And then they like never delivered the food to them. They ended up getting a refund from Grubhub. Maybe like bonus refund too, like, hey, here's an extra order on us. But I've had it happen. It does happen where the driver orders food and it looks so good that he's got to eat it on the way to deliver the food. And that happened to one video, or one person. I don't know what the state, but the Grubhub driver was actually caught on surveillance camera in his own car eating the customer's food. This is all part of the plan called Eat the Grubhub.
Hungry? Yeah, me too. That's why there's Eat the Grubhub, the only food delivery service that'll leave everybody happy.
How's it work?
It's easy. You order the food, I drive it to your house, I park in front of your house, I eat the food because I'm hungry too, and I tell you how it is. Then I give you the leftovers. You'll love ordering food on Eat the Grubhub.
Yes?
Yeah, I got half a calzone here, and it's so good. Really cheesy. I left you a few bites.
But where are the breadsticks?
Oh, those were really good, so I ate all of them. Yeah, you got any soda in there so I can wash them down?
Please leave.
Eat the Grubhub. Order food and have me eat some of the food today.
There you go. Let's see what's going on in From Grubhub to Grub Gab, the world of food. All right, starting off with Taco Bell, they just keep on announcing new items to their menu, including returning favorites and brand new innovations. So here we go, cheesy street chalupas. These consist of a quesalupa shell stuffed with mozzarella and pepper jack cheeses blended together, a choice of grilled steak or shredded chicken with a flavorful sauce and topped with diced onions and cilantro. That being tested in Indianapolis. Toasted breakfast tacos. They're $1.49, feature fluffy eggs, melted cheese, and a choice of bacon, sausage, or potatoes. If you want to try some for free, rewards members get their chance today, actually, October 17th, 24th, and 31st. Large nacho fries, so they're a bigger size than the regular nacho fries. They also have nacho fries with vegan nacho sauce. This is the first vegan item Taco Bell has offered nationwide. And crispy chicken nuggets, we talked about this yesterday. These are being tested in the Minneapolis, Minnesota market. Chick-fil-A coming to Danville will open up sometime expected around Christmas and just released its first ever digital cookbook called Extra Helpings, inspiring stories and inventive recipes from Chick-fil-A's shared table in an effort to raise awareness about combating food security and reducing food waste. It contains 26 recipes inspired by Chick-fil-A shared table, a food donation program founded in 2012, and it's free to download. The program encourages Chick-fil-A locations to donate surplus food to local nonprofit organizations that take the surplus food and make hot meals like the ones included in this cookbook. Some of the items include breaded chicken fajitas, chicken enchiladas, chicken and egg breakfast casserole, and even their famous coleslaw and their discontinued Chick-fil-A chicken salad. Chick-fil-A will also donate $150,000 to Feeding America and Second Harvest and $100,000 to each of their 7 Chick-fil-A shared table nonprofit partners. And Papa John's expanding their fan-favorite Papa Bites lineup with the release of the new Twix Papa Bites. Features the brand's signature dough loaded up with the creamy cheesecake filling and Twix cookie bar pieces, then cut into 8 bite-sized pieces and baked until golden brown. Each Twix Papa Bites carries a suggested price of $4.99 and includes a cup of sweet caramel sauce for either dipping or drizzling. Papa John's releases new Twix Papa Bites, Chick-fil-A, first ever digital cookbook, Taco Bell, exciting new menu items, Grub Gab, the world of food where you can just eat it. It's 8:47. James the Gardener will be in here next, and we'll also see what's gone on this date in rock and roll, pop, and R&B music history right here on The Joe Show, WHIR Danville.
When it comes to taking your medication, are you really following your doctor's directions? Your friends at the Medicine Shop Pharmacy at 900 Houstonville Road understand the difficulty of following a medication program, especially if you are taking multiple medications, maintaining a busy schedule, experiencing side effects, or feeling better. But your Medicine Shop Pharmacist also understands the importance of taking your medication properly. Regardless if you are maintaining an ongoing treatment program or if you're just taking a one-time prescription, it is vital that you take your medication as prescribed so that you receive the fullest benefits. The Medicine Shop offers free weekly medication packaging. We customize your medication therapy and deliver your weekly package, all with no additional charge to you. Let us simplify your therapy and maximize your treatment plan. Visit the Medicine Shop Pharmacy at 900 Houstonville Road or call 238-0002 for more information about the importance of medication compliance. It's just another healthy reminder from the pharmacy that's all about your health.
Hello, Central Kentucky. I'm Steve Bertram with sports. Last night in the opening round of the girls' state high school soccer tournament, 12th region champ Boyle County defeated 11th region champ Madison Central 2-0 at Rebel Stadium. The Lady Rebels now advance to the Elite Eight Thursday night. Boyle has posted shutouts in 5 of its 6 postseason games. There were 2 games in baseball's league championship series Monday. In the ALCS, Texas jumped out to a 5-1 lead, then held off Houston for a 5-3 win and a 2-0 lead in the series. Game 3 is in Arlington tomorrow night. In Game 1 of the NLCS, Philadelphia jumped out on top of Arizona 5-0, then held off the Diamondbacks to win Game 1 5-3. Game 2 starters tonight, Aaron Nola for the Phillies against Merrill Kelly for the Diamondbacks. In the NFL Monday night special, Dallas defeated the LA Chargers 20-17. Cowboys improved 4-2, while the Chargers dropped to 2-3. Georgia remains number 1 in the AP College Football Top 25 this week. Louisville fell to 21st, and Kentucky dropped out. The Bulldogs are followed in the top 5 by Michigan, Ohio State, Florida State, and Oklahoma. Other SEC schools ranked this week are Alabama at number 11, Ole Miss 13th, Tennessee 17th, LSU 19th, and Missouri is 20th. Kentucky has an open date this week and will host number 17 Tennessee on October 28th. Boyle County shortstop Cam Owens has committed to playing baseball at the University of Kentucky. Owens, a rising senior in a class of 24, hit .481 last year with 9 homers and 40 ribbies. We'll have the Kentucky men's basketball blue-white scrimmage on the air this Saturday from Northern Kentucky University. Pre-game show start at 5:30. Tip-off is at 6 on Z105. All proceeds from the game go to Eastern Kentucky Flood Relief and Western Kentucky Tornado Relief. That's sports. God bless America. I'm Steve Bertram on the Hometown Radio Network.
Hi, former CIA officer and survival expert Jason Hansen here. I teach people how to prepare for the unexpected. And right now, most Americans with a 401k, IRA, or other types of retirement accounts are not prepared for a financial crisis that could hit the U.S. in the next 45 days if we don't fix our ramped up government spending. I have partnered with Advantage Gold, the number one rated precious metals company in America, to release my new financial crisis survival kit that's 100% free for everyone with a retirement account who calls in today. Simply call 800-900-8000. My financial crisis survival kit is jam-packed with valuable information on how you can protect yourself with physical gold and silver. Your first step to protection is calling 800-900-8000 and speaking to one of their gold IRA specialists.
Advantage Gold is not an investment advisor or a tax advisor. Check with your financial advisor before investing.
Again, simply call 800-900-8000.
Hi, this is Karen, and at ADA Heating and Air, we offer free estimates on replacements. We install American Standard heating and air conditioning equipment. Our employees do not work on commission, so you don't pay for unnecessary repairs. We offer the best pricing around. On average, we can save you 15%. We offer same or next day service. Financing is available on our website at adaheatingandair.com. Call ADA today for all your HVAC needs at 859-519-6382. ADA is on the way.
The Hometown Radio Network sports broadcast schedule brought to you by Monticello Bank. High school football Friday night. Danville host Breathitt County on 103.9 FM WHIR. Boyle County host Wayne County on Z104. And Mercer County is at Garrett County. The Garrett broadcast on hometownlive.net. The Mercer broadcast on 99.5 FM WHBN. All of those games kick off at 7:30. Meanwhile, on Saturday, the Cats are on bye this week. They take on Tennessee the following week at Kroger Field.
This Joe Show weather report brought to you by...
Well, thanks for that, Jack. Brought to you by Danville Auto Body Shop. For top-of-the-line collision and auto body repair, head to the mechanics at Danville Auto Body Shop, James. 315 DeLahaye, call for an appointment, 236-2299. That's 236-2299 for Danville Auto Body Shop. Sunshine, a high of 58, or partly sunny, I should say, high of 58, low of 39. You do get sunshine fully tomorrow, high of 70. On Thursday, showers are likely, a high of 67. Right now, it's 8:53 in the morning. What's going on with James the Gardener today?
Just trying to stay warm this morning. Got a nice little chill out there, and had to go back in and readjust my clothing this morning because it wasn't quite right. So now things are good. You know, we're moving right along into the fall season, and fall is doing what it's supposed to. You know, temperatures are falling. So let's see what else is going on. Sometime tomorrow, we'll have the FFA. You know, they'll be up at Constitution Square helping me to remove the flowers.
Okay.
You know, so this way their job is done for the season.
Yeah.
And, you know, we look forward to having them back again next year.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy going out there and working with them in the greenhouses. You know, because I've never been a greenhouse type person.
Yeah.
Until, you know, actually, you know, went out there and worked with them. You know, it was a lot of fun. Learned some nice little tips from them. Make me want to have a greenhouse. You know, but I want to, you know, say maybe a 30-foot one. I don't want to.
We got land here.
Yeah, sure. And Robert here just let me set one up right in the back.
It's okay with me.
Not a problem.
You have my permission.
All right.
Now, I'm the lowest one on the totem pole here, but...
but why not?
Go for it.
Go for it.
I say go for it, James.
Yeah, you know, and Robert, he's got a greenhouse over there.
There you go, yeah.
You know, so he could give me some tips on greenhouse. So, yeah, maybe we can work something out.
Yeah, you imagine you putting a greenhouse up and Robert pulls in. Like, James, what are you doing? And Joe told me I could do it. Oh.
Really?
Well, okay.
Well, let me go talk to Joe and see if we can figure that one out.
What's going on here?
Right. But let's see here. But I did want to talk a little bit about, because there's 10 native flowers that you can plant that will come back yearly. Mm-hmm. And the best thing about that is, you know, if once you grow these flowers, you can easily deadhead them. You know, when they turn nice and brown and you know, they look dead.
Yeah.
Then you take those seeds and save them. Because, you know, one pack of native flower seeds are like $3.99. And if you, you know, have grown this, say, Black Hat Susan, You had a really nice bush and you cut off, you know, say 10 of them, you know, I guess there's maybe like 25 or 30 seeds in each of the little heads. You could save yourself a bunch of money. But the Blackout Susans, the Cosmos, the Four O'Clocks, the Hollyhock, the Marigolds, Nasturtium, and Purple Coneflower, Sunflower Seeds, the Zinnia Seeds, you know, those are great plants to have around your yard because, like I said, they do come back. And like I said, if you do cut the heads off of them and save those seeds, you know, and when you cut the heads off, you put them in a brown paper bag and put them in a nice cool place. And oh, and when, say, 3 to 4 weeks or so, every now and then you go and you shake that bag, you know, shake those flower heads around to get those seeds out.
Yeah.
Like I say, you know, you're probably talking, you know, maybe $75 or more just in seeds, just from cutting the heads off of it. So
yeah,
grow native plants as often as you can. Because, like I said, they're used to the zone 6B that we live in, which means that the weather is gets up to 100 and sometimes it drops down to in the 20s. So it kind of adjusts to the weather here. So it works real well by saving seeds.
There you go. Gardening with James. Tuesdays and Thursdays right here on The Joe Show on 103.9 FM WHIR. All right, James, we got you in studio. Let's get your opinion on some candies, okay?
Let's do it.
Halloween candy bracket. We are in the Sweet 16 trying to move a couple of candies on to the Elite Eight.
Okay.
As we have two matchups for you to pick from today. It's the bottom left quadrant of the bracket, James.
Okay.
Number 2-seeded Twix taking on 7th-seeded Starburst. Who you have?
I can go with Twix.
Twix takes a 3-1 lead now over Starburst.
All right.
I would say starting to pull away, but have a couple of more votes that are left today. And okay. Jaeger will probably be in here. Dusty will be in here as well. So they'd have a chance if they wanted to, if they don't pick Twix, to tie it up with Twix and Starburst. So we'll see how that one plays out. Right now, though, James, depending on who you pick, this could seal it for one of these candy bars here.
Okay.
Three Musketeers, the 11 seed, going up against the 3-seeded classic chocolate Hershey bars.
Oh, it's got to be a Hershey bar.
So Hershey bars, that's 4-0. More than likely we'll move on unless we have an influx of angry Three Musketeers mobsters that call in and say, we demand Three Musketeers move on. I'm casting my vote for Three Musketeers. It looks as if Hershey bars will move on.
Because, you know, Hershey's got a nice chocolate flavor, you know, you can, you know what you're getting every time.
Yeah.
But when you do the other, it's like, okay, you ate it, but there's no leftovers.
Yeah, well, I talked about this earlier this morning. I'm not sure that there are many people that could tell you what a Three Musketeers bar tastes like.
No.
So just blindfolded, I hand you a Three Musketeers. You don't know. You're blindfolded. Right. You eat it.
Right.
How many people would be able to tell me, oh, that's a Three Musketeers bar?
That'd be hard to do.
It'd be hard to do.
Yeah.
Because people don't eat them. Because people don't hand them out often.
Right.
Now, I don't mind the Nestle Crunch upset. That's who Three Musketeers beat. Because to me, Crunch is also a really boring candy bar.
Yeah.
It's been around forever.
Yep.
But many great candies have surpassed Nestle Crunch. I feel like Nestle Crunch is one of those that has been around since like the 1930s when you could buy candy for like a penny.
Yeah.
Like you go to the old country store and they'd pull out a Crunch bar and you were excited about it because it had Rice Krispies inside chocolate.
Right.
What an innovation.
Right.
But it's been far surpassed by many other candies.
Yeah, because, and don't get me wrong, I do like Rice Krispies cereal every now and then.
Yeah.
You know, but you really don't taste it either.
No.
You know, it's like, oh, you've tasted the crunch, the milk. Okay, that was all that was left.
Rice Krispies inside it. So I don't mind Three Musketeers beating Nestle Crunch.
Right.
But to me, Three Musketeers can't stand on its own. The only way you'd know a Three Musketeers bar is if I gave you like three candy bars, a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup, a Butterfinger, a Three Musketeers. You would know the other two.
Oh, yeah.
And by process of elimination, you'd know Three Musketeers just because you know the other two.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. All right, 9 o'clock in the morning, 103.9 FM, WHIR, Danville.
It's 9 o'clock.
NBC News Radio, I'm Michael Kastner. A vote for the new Speaker of the House is expected today. House Democratic Whip Catherine Clark confirms the vote on Representative Jim Jordan will happen, but it's still unclear if Jordan will gather enough votes to secure the position. While the GOP holds a slight majority in the House, only 4 votes can be sacrificed to win, with some Republicans expressing concern about Jordan. President Biden is taking a trip to Israel. Secretary of State Antony Blinken made the announcement after meeting with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Netanyahu. Biden is expected to meet with the prime minister and other Israeli leaders. Attorney General Merrick Garland is opening a federal hate crimes investigation into the death of a child. Mark Mayfield explains.
The six-year-old Chicago boy was stabbed over two dozen times on Saturday. His mother was also injured in the attack that authorities say was carried out by the family's landlord. He's now charged with first-degree murder, aggravated battery with a deadly weapon, and two counts of a hate crime. Evidence gathered suggests the family was targeted due to their Islamic faith and the Israel-Hamas war. In a statement issued late Sunday night, President Biden said both he and First Lady Jill Biden were sickened to learn of the brutal murder. He added, there is no place in America for hate against anyone.
Hundreds gathered yesterday for the boy's funeral at the Mosque Foundation in Bridgeview, Illinois. That includes the governor of Illinois and the mayor of Chicago. Former President Trump is not to talk with witnesses about his federal case regarding his handling of classified documents. That order came from Magistrate Judge Jonathan Goodman during Trump's arraignment hearing yesterday that saw him plead not guilty. The indictment against Trump alleges he stored classified information at his Mar-a-Lago residence that included U.S. nuclear programs and defense and weapons capabilities. During a campaign trip to Iowa, Trump said he plans to appeal the judge's decision. He claimed the Justice Department has been weaponized against him. Michael Kastner, NBC News Radio.
Do you or someone you know struggle with hearing issues? Many rural Kentuckians are underserved when it comes to hearing health care. That's why the Heiser Hearing Institute developed Kentucky Hears, a program aimed at removing barriers to care and providing equal access to hearing health care. Kentucky Hears offers everything from hearing screenings to cochlear implant resources. Visit kyhears.org to learn more. Kentucky Hears, because everyone deserves to experience the sound of life.
The Kentucky Department for Community-Based Services is hiring. DCBS invites you to be part of an inclusive team of caring professionals that helps all Kentucky families through a rewarding career in family support or social services. They have job openings in their county offices across the state and offer great benefits like hybrid work schedule, competitive salary, paid holidays, and many opportunities for training and promotions, plus state employee discounts. Go online to chfs.ky.gov and enter DCBS jobs in the search field. It's a new day at DCBS. Join them, an equal opportunity employer, MFD.
Missing persons flyers are being put up in San Diego, calling attention to victims of the Israel-Hamas war. They're causing controversy, though. Trey Thomas with more.
Ina Vallavi, with the group organizing the flyers, says they're only putting them up in public places.
We are asking people to put it only in public places to respect the communities. Publishing these stories of the people that cannot speak is the freedom of speech. It is not a hate crime.
But local Islamic groups are concerned about the flyers and reported them to police as possible hate incidents. Some were reportedly found at the Islamic Center of San Diego in Claremont. I'm Trey Thomas.
Whoopi Goldberg says she gave Pope Francis memorabilia from her hit 1992 film Sister Act. The actress told her co-hosts on The View Monday that she visited the pontiff last week and showed off a video of the trip. Goldberg said Francis is exactly what she hoped he would be, a pope for all people, regardless of religion. In the movie, Goldberg plays a lounge singer who goes into a witness protection program disguised as a nun. Actress Suzanne Somers' husband of 46 years is speaking out following her passing.
This was an amazing woman. And the idea that she's gone has affected a lot of people, not just our family.
Alan Hamill tells the Today Show her death on Sunday was peaceful. He said he was grateful that he was able to be with her at the end. Somers gained fame in the mid-1970s as Chrissy Snow on the hit comedy Three's Company. In addition to her acting roles, Somers had her own line of health, beauty, and fitness products. Michael Kastner, NBC News.
Waking up on the right side. This is the Sean Hannity Morning Minute.
Look at the appeasement of Obama, Biden, and now Biden alone towards Iran, the number one state sponsor of terror. It is inexplicable. But now already the media mob, memories short as they are, just within a week after these horrific terror attacks, massive amounts of human casualties, you know, kidnapping of innocent people as hostages, children, babies with their heads decapitated, more video evidence you could ever want or imagine, and then, you know, then we see Friday on a mass scale, the numbers of people that are protesting, and I'm watching them, and I'm like, what part of Israel being the victim here are these people not understanding?
From coast to coast, from sea to shining sea, it's the Sean Hannity Show.
Now, it's all making sense. Earlier this year, gold bubbled around $1,800 an ounce. But then the banks crashed. The president proposed a $4.7 trillion tax hike, and the Federal Reserve quietly started working on a digital dollar. But Americans did not like that, which is why gold shot past $2,000 and could even spike to $2,500. The economy's going down. The dollar's going down. And gold's going up. Fast, and right now could be your last opportunity to protect your wealth. So write this down, because you'll not only get the chance to protect your retirement savings with gold and silver, you could get up to $10,000 in free silver from Sean Hannity's partner, Goldco. You heard that right, $10,000 in free silver from Goldco when you call 855-815-GOLD. So don't miss what could be your best opportunity to protect your retirement savings today. Call 855-815-GOLD. That's 855-815-GOLD.
A&M Diesel Automotive and Truck Repair in Danville, located on Lebanon Road, is family-owned and operated. A&M Diesel specializes in both diesel and gas repairs, such as brake work, front-end repairs, oil changes, tune-ups, and more on most all vehicles. They provide both major and minor repairs, and they're your Jasper Engine and Transmission dealer, plus Jeremy and Corey are both certified diesel mechanics, and they offer honest prices and walk-ins are welcome. For your appointment, call 859-332-7026. A&M Diesel, Lebanon Road, in Danville.
The Parthenon Greek American eats, dine in, or take out.
Fresh
from our family. Fresh Mediterranean and American. A gathering place, always a treat. Specialty gyros, great burgers and fries. Whatever your craving will satisfy. The Parthenon Greek American eats, dine in, or take out.
Fresh.
In Danville, Lexington Road.
Good morning to you folks. It's Tuesday. It's October the 17th. It's 9:08 in the morning, 49 degrees. We got a forecast coming your way and news coming up here first and Dusty after that. Well, let me get the news playing here. There we go.
This is a Hometown Radio Network information update.
Ephraim McDowell Health is now helping fight food insecurity with the Ephraim McDowell Food Assistance Partnership Program. The program provides individual boxes of non-perishable food for food insecure patients and their families upon discharge from any of Ephraim's three hospitals, Ephraim McDowell Regional Medical Center in Danville, Fort Logan Hospital in Stanford, and Hagen Hospital in Harrodsburg. The food boxes include shelf-stable meal items that are easy to cook and is intended to feed a patient and their family for up to 2 days. Families can participate in the Food Assistance Partnership based on their responses to a survey they take when they're admitted to the hospital. It's Frank X. Walker Creative Arts Festival Week at the Danville School System this week. The event started yesterday and continued today with a Frank X. Walker Artist Talk for the middle and high school students. Tomorrow with the Frank X. Walker readings at Hogsett and Tolliver. And then Thursday and Friday with the creative art workshops in the schools. There will also be an opening reception and a Frank X. Walker visual art exhibit beginning today and going through October 28th. Frank X. Walker is a Danville High School graduate who was appointed Poet Laureate of Kentucky in 2013, the first African-American to hold that position. And two school resource officers will have their own SRO vehicles thanks to a donation to Lincoln County Schools. The Ohio County Sheriff's Office recently donated 2 used police cars to Lincoln County Schools and the Stanford Police Department. Lincoln Schools says the vehicles will be used for their school resource officers. The first phase of repairs to the Anderson Dean Park pool have been approved. The Harrodsburg Herald reports that at their last park board meeting, the board of directors approved a $175,400 bid from American Leak Detection of Mount Washington for phase one of those pool repairs. The Anderson Dean Park pool had been closed since June after officials learned the pool had leaked 1 million gallons of water in its first week it was open.
And remember, today is the pop-up driver's licensing program in Lincoln County. Last year, the state changed where you get your licenses and renew them by making regional driver's license offices. However, it's still inconvenient for some to get to those other counties. So to make it easier, they're hosting pop-up programs. In our area, Lincoln County will host a pop-up driver's license program today at the Lincoln County Public Library. Meanwhile, Mercer County will have theirs on Thursday at the Mercer County Courthouse. You can register online at the Kentucky Transportation Cabinet website, drive.ky.gov. I'm Joe Mathis.
This Joe Show weather report brought to you by...
It's brought to you by Dexter and Reitmeier Insurance. This is going to look awfully weird in the live stream. As Dusty is underneath the desk, underneath me, and he's working on a speaker which has a hum here in the studio. So Dusty on the live stream is going to pop up out of nowhere. All right, partly sunny, high of 58, low tonight 40. Sunshine tomorrow 70. Thursday, showers likely, mostly cloudy, high of 67. Right now it's 9:11 in the morning. It's 49 degrees. There you go, Dusty. We'll let you climb out of there. Hold on, you're caught up in my headphones. There you are. Hey, that's the type of service you get from Pro Sound and Lights. I mean, middle of a radio show. Let's see if we can get the speaker in here working. What have you diagnosed, Dusty? There's a hum in the speaker. What have you diagnosed?
Yes, so there's only hum in one speaker. So that tells me that so the way usually the systems are hooked up is you got your feed that comes into your amplifier, and then that's from the board, and then from the amplifier out to the speaker, right? So if there's a hum in only one side, then you're looking to trace it down to that one side of the amplifier. And then you want to eliminate that problem or eliminate the amplifier in it. So maybe during the break or after the show, or I could just be down there working on it while you're talking to Ann Yeager. I think that'd be good. You would switch it. So see if the hum follows the amp channel, right?
Yeah.
So I would switch the wires on the speakers to see if it follows the amp
channel. And then the hum would be in the other speaker at that point.
Well,
If it does. If it follows the amp channel.
Exactly. So then that tells me, all right, then I'll switch it back, and then I will switch the inputs that come in, because right now you have two inputs that feed it. And so I would switch those inputs to see if it follows that.
See, folks?
And then you just trace it. You just keep going back and back and back.
And this is a professional here.
I mean, yeah, okay.
This isn't amateur sound and lights. This is pro sound and lights.
So we always talk about sound as a flow. So it flows. Like it flows from your golden majestic vocal cords into the microphone, from the microphone into the mixer that's older than both of us combined.
This mixer's not that old. We just put this in like 7 years ago.
It's sitting in the box for how long?
You really think this mixer's older than 30 years old?
Yes.
This mixer's not.
I think that mixer's from the 80s.
The mixer in there is old.
But yeah, but it's the same mixer.
I'm pointing into the... No, it's not.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, isn't it the same mixer? They just had a new one in the box that you guys just had, and you just put it in here?
No.
I don't know. I think that's right.
They redid this studio like 10 years ago. So.
Well, so it flows from the mixer to the amplifier and from the amplifier to the speaker, and that's how sound flows, right? And so you just think of it as a stream, and you either work up or down the lines to figure out where the problems are.
It's amazing that all that can happen without there being a delay.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, all that simultaneously. Like, I've got headphones on, and you do too, and we're speaking to the microphone, and we hear as we're talking.
Sure.
I mean, all of it's simultaneous as we're talking.
Yeah, and I mean, I'm sure there's like, if you were to measure it, and technically there'd probably be like milliseconds of delays that we just can't.
Millisecond.
Yeah, we just can't break it down enough.
Because our brains are not that quick. Because
we
got deadhead, as James said in his gardening segment, deadhead, and that's how our heads are, they're dead. Our brains don't function properly.
All I know is I turned on and you guys were besmirching the good name of Nestle Crunch Bars.
Do you like Nestle Crunch?
I like Nestle Crunch Bars. I'm not afraid to admit it.
I'm not saying they're bad, but they're boring.
It's just chocolate and Rice Krispies in it, yeah. But it's still good. Would you rather have a Hershey bar or a Nestle Crunch bar?
Hershey.
No, Nestle Crunch. You got to go Nestle Crunch.
Is it the same company? No, Nestle and Hershey are two different companies,
yes,
aren't they?
Yeah.
I was going to say, if it's the same company, then you have to go Hershey's.
Hershey makes the crackle.
I'd rather have a crunch than a crackle. The crackles are you never see the full size.
Yeah, you never
crackles.
See a full
they're
size.
They're always fun size, and they're in the red. And there's Mr. Good Bar.
There's Mr. Good. You never see a Mr. Good Bar full size.
No, those are okay. Yeah. Crackles are boring.
Special
I'd rather
darks.
Have a crunch than a crackle. I don't like dark chocolate much.
Well, I mean, Hershey's Special Dark is not really, it's not really dark chocolate. Like, you got to go to, like, Whole Foods and get the bougie, like, oh, this is, like, from, you know, a person who's been massaged all day. Like, this is from that chocolate company, like.
Godiva.
Yeah.
Isn't that it? Godiva or something like that? The chocolate company? Godiva?
Yeah. But Godiva?
Godiva or something like
Godiva.
That?
Godiva, yeah.
So, since we're talking candy, you go ahead and vote, Dusty. Twix or Starburst?
Ooh.
Tough second round game.
That is, because it's like, do you either go fruity or chocolate? Okay, if I'm looking at them, I'm going Starburst.
Yeah.
I'm rolling Starburst.
Starburst.
Sometimes I like to take a Starburst and mush them together. Yeah, and then chew on them.
You, Coach Haddix. Voted Starburst.
Okay.
The other people, not calling them old, but older than us, James Bean won, voted Twix.
With Twix.
What do you think I'm going to vote?
Starburst.
I'm telling you. Like, it's just the way it works. People who, I don't know what the age cutoff is. Okay. We'll say somewhere in the 50s, late 40s, early 50s, that's the cutoff. Those people are not voting for chewy, gummy, fruity candies. They're just not going to.
I think they probably think it's more childish.
It's exactly right, what it is.
Yeah.
And we act like children.
I'm a child that's grown old.
My favorite thing, one of my favorite foods, fruit gushers.
Oh, yeah. Excellent.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right? Like, to me, we never really had fruit snacks in the house growing up. So,
we always had fruit gummies, right? Like, they're like.
Did you eat them all the time?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, constantly having gushers, to restock because you're eating fruit gummies. It's a childish thing. It's seen as childish. So. "Quote unquote," adults are not going to vote. They would rather have boring Nestle Crunch than chewy, gummy, fruity candies. James, what do you think about it? We're talking about you right now.
Say there you go.
Right in front of James, we're talking about him.
Well, for me, it's I like the fruities. I like gummies. You know, those things are cool. You know, but when it comes to, this is my sitting down time and thinking time. I want something that I can kind of enjoy the flavor. So I put away my childish things and eat adult toast.
Sounds like I'm reading the Bible. Right?
I know, yeah.
Put away the childish things.
Yeah, yeah. He's going to sit down, eat the Nestle Crunch, and read, I can't think of a book of a Bible right now. Deuteronomy. That's
Ezekiel.
Yeah, Deuteronomy.
Right.
Look, I've found a concoction that when I'm out calling Danville football games late on Friday nights, right, so like Leslie County, it was a two-hour trip home, and I didn't get home to 1 o'clock in the morning. Well, I was here, you know, waking up at 5 o'clock in the morning, so it was a 20-hour day for me that Friday.
Yeah. Right.
But I found a concoction years ago that helps keep me up on those long drives.
Red Bull.
No, well, I don't want to be that over the top. I get home, and my heart's pounding through my chest.
Now you can't sleep it off.
Yeah.
Coffee? And sour gummy worms or some sort of gummy candy. So to me, gummy candy has kept me alive many late Friday nights. So it's hard to argue against gummy candy for me.
I mean,
fruity candy.
The only other thing is like your jaw gets sore if you try to eat like a whole thing of Starburst.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, after a while, jaws get tired. Yeah.
Now, I like a good Twix bar. Don't get me wrong. I had a good Twix bar.
But if it came down to fun-sized Twix bar, couple of Starbursts in the fun size pack. What would you pick?
Oh, I'm going Starburst.
Yeah. I think I would too.
Yeah, and like, because I whenever you asked me that, I was like, okay, if there was the where they're selling candy for fundraisers, which are they allowed to do that anymore?
Yeah, they still do. Yeah.
They still do. Okay, and then they open up the whole box. It's like, I'm going for that Starburst if it's there.
Yeah,
right.
There you go. All right, so it's 3-2 Twix over Starburst. I'm going to go ahead and cast my vote for Starburst as well, which ties it up at 3, which means unless we have phone calls in.
No, is it Ann Yeager or is it going to be?
I don't know. It's going
to. Did it decide it last week? Over Twizzlers over.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, Mary Stith voted for Twizzlers over Nerds or whatever it was.
Okay.
So. I don't know. I don't necessarily think the age is always the deciding factor. Like, you could just really like chocolate, right? Sure. And maybe that's why Twix is your favorite candy bar of all time.
You could be allergic to peanut butter, and you can't have Reese's.
So I'm not voting for Reese's.
Right.
The fact of the matter is, there seems to be a trend. Older, you're not voting gummies. Younger, you're voting gummies.
Yeah, gummies are good.
So, by the way, my mom is upset, not like angry, like spitting at the radio.
Irate.
She said, I'm not listening to you anymore, Joe. I'm done. Because I had the gall to blaspheme Three Musketeers.
Well, Three Musketeers is not a good candy bar.
Do you think the argument, though, that I made that you would not know blindfolded. If I handed you a Three Musketeers and didn't tell you what it was, said just eat this, you took a bite, that you would know which candy bar it was.
Yeah, because Three Musketeers has a like that. It's fluffier. It's like a lighter.
Okay.
Texture.
See, I didn't. Well, I don't remember what Three Musketeers is.
It's got the chocolate on the outside, but fluffy on the inside.
Inside, okay. Wasn't the whole there was a whole ad campaign where like the Three Musketeers would float, right?
Right.
Because it was so light.
Oh.
And it would also be like the better choice, like the diet candy bar almost. And apparently,
which makes me want to not choose it even more.
Right. Yeah, and apparently like they did like, what was it, Barstool did like the most candy passed out, and like Three Musketeers made it for like Kentucky. And I was like, I don't know anybody who passes out a Three Musketeers.
Yeah. All right. So Three Musketeers or Hershey's?
Oh, Hershey's. Come on, Hershey's.
Yeah, it's over. Hershey bars moves on to the Elite Eight.
It's classic. Like, you don't put... Like, Hershey's can go with so many different things, and it's great. Like, s'mores, it's all time.
Oh, yeah.
You don't put Three Musketeers on a s'more. That's gross.
No.
Yeah. You don't put Three Musketeers in your mouth. You just leave it alone
in the
can.
At the convenience store.
You know why they give it away at Halloween? Because they don't want to eat it.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the last one they had. Yeah. That's right.
Why are there not as many Reese's? Because we're eating all the Reese's before it gets Halloween time.
There has to be a bag of Reese's for me and then a bag of Reese's for everybody else.
That's right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Music. What do we got in music?
Music. We got a lot of stuff coming on. I had a good time with Strutter.
Yeah, how was that last Friday? The Kiss cover band Strutter?
The Kiss cover band Strutter. It was a good show. They are excellent performers. It was a little awkward, though, because I felt like maybe I heard them wrong, or maybe this is like your mind just tricks you into it, but I thought I heard them referring to themselves like as if they were Kiss members.
Okay.
Like, oh, no, that's Gene's mic, and this is Pete's mic, and that's Ace's mic.
Like, even before, like during mic check?
Yeah, like as we were setting up.
So, like, they're always in character.
Right. And, like, they come in, like, they do the whole face paint. They have, like, the big, like, big boots on. Okay, so it makes them, like, super tall. And, I mean, they were excellent, like, good guitar players. The bassist was super nice and awesome. The lead singer was a little picky and flat. And so it's like, you can't be both.
Oh, okay. Picky and flat.
Yeah. And they were all deaf. They could not hear anything.
Well, imagine that
cranking those monitors up.
You've made a career out of this, right? Yeah. And so you listen to loud music all the time. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of kids just walked in here.
I don't know what's going on.
Maybe they're going to be on Rick's show. I bet they're with the Mercer County FFA.
Okay.
That's probably what it is. Anyway, so Strutter went well.
Strutter, it was a good show. We popped the breakers for the very first song.
Okay.
They came out and was like, "Bagow!" and just shut the whole thing down.
So what happens then?
We panic and we
you flip. Start rewiring stuff.
So here's what
start
we learned.
Start chasing it down to the amp channel and see if the hum carries over to the next speaker. Stuff like that.
So we learned our lesson from the last time because we tripped the breakers to the subwoofers. And so this time, as we were setting up, we... Pro Sound labeled the breakers and the outlets for the people.
Yeah.
And so, because of course they weren't labeled.
Yeah.
And so we labeled them all. So that way, whenever it did trip, we were like, oh, we plugged the array in to, circuit two.
Yeah. And so we just work for them.
Yes. Yeah. Because it makes it easier on us.
Yeah. 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 So it went well after that, then, after you got it fixed.
And this was the first time that I've been a part of a show that was protested. There was a church that protested the event.
Why?
Because of what you said earlier. Like, it's very, like...
I did mention last week.
Yeah.
I always felt like Kiss had this satanic feel to it.
And they thought so as well.
Whether or not that's justified. I don't know if that's justified or not, but I just felt that way. Because they had long tongues, like serpents, and they painted their faces in black and white.
Yeah, and I mean, like, in Gene Simmons' character is called the Demon. And, like, he does, like,
a
whole
thing. I didn't know that, but it adds to it.
Right? There's, like, Star Child, Catman, or Catboy. I don't know. He's the drummer. And then...
Catboy. Back there pounding the drums.
Right. And he was deaf as a doornail, man. He couldn't hear anything. And, like, they don't have in-ear monitors. Anyway. And so, like, but there's a part where Gene comes in and, like, he either, like, bites his tongue or bites something. And, like, he has, like, fake blood that dribbles down.
Yeah.
All right?
I'm not into that.
And it was... He did it over our monitor, which was kind of bad.
What was it?
Is this like fake blood? Like, yeah.
What was the fake thing he bit into, though?
I don't know. I wasn't like I was working behind, and so
I don't know if I'm going to protest it, but I'm not going to go. You know, like
sure. But I mean, okay. I will say, to their credit, I was singing a lot more Kiss songs that I recognized.
I figured that there had to be more than just like two.
Right.
That you
Dr.
knew.
Love, which I had no idea was a Kiss song.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Love.
That was in the Dr. Pepper commercials
was
for
it?
A couple years, right?
I don't know. You remember different ads, and I remember different ads.
Yeah.
That's how it works, right?
So who else we got? What are we going to go
Let's see. And then, of course, we had Vinyl Richie, which was Saturday for that wedding. That went awesome. Mm-hmm. That was a great show. Had a good time. And then they're going to be playing in the Virginia Theater in Somerset on November 4th, I believe. And then they also announced that we're doing a 90s New Year's Eve party at Manchester Music Hall.
Oh, cool. Are you going to be the DJ?
I am DJing.
90s, the best decade of music. You got a lot of great jams to pick from.
But here's the thing. So I have to coordinate with the band.
Okay.
Because there's two bands.
Are they 90s cover bands?
Well, one of them is Vinyl Richie. And so they're doing a whole 90s like set list.
Yeah.
And so I got to make sure I'm not playing what they're going to be playing.
Mm-hmm.
But luckily, it's like they don't lean heavy towards hip-hop. Like, they do a few songs like Gin and Juice. And they also do a TLC song or something like that.
Okay.
And so they have it blended in there.
Waterfalls, isn't that a TLC song? Don't Go Chasing Waterfalls.
Or No Scrubs, right? And so, but I'm DJing like their breaks and then in between bands. And then like I'm DJing on into the night.
Okay.
So they're going to go all the way up to like midnight. And I think after that, I carry on to like 2.
Okay.
And then, I'm thinking about, I don't have to run sound there either. That's the amazing thing.
You just get
to
focus on the music.
I'm just DJing, yeah.
Cool.
And I'm thinking I found a prop master, which is one of our friends that works with me. It's one of his friends.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's Will's friend. And he makes realistic armor as props for,
cool.
like, video games. Like, he did an opener for, like, Elden Ring. And
awesome.
Made like where he made a whole suit of armor.
Wow.
Right?
Okay.
And so I was thinking about getting, like, a big head with like glowing horns to wear.
To wear while okay. So, do you have a DJ name?
Well, okay. So, here was the debate because I had to give one because whenever they were booking. And so I bounced it off a few people. And the first one we came up with was DJ White Wildman.
Okay.
And that didn't work.
No.
It didn't work. And so, my wife suggested DJ D Dub because my initials are DJW.
Yeah.
So
DW Dusty Wesley DJ D Dub.
D Dub. And so that's what we went with.
Okay, that's cool. D-dub. I like that. Yeah. DJ D Dub. I can get behind that.
And so I was thinking, have you ever played apparently it was a popular game that I didn't know. It's called like Shovel Knight.
Never heard of it.
Okay, neither did I. But apparently, it's like, I think it's that next generation of gamers that know Shovel Knight.
All right.
But that's like the horns that I want to get.
All
like,
right.
It's like a helmet with horns.
Look like Shovel Knight.
Yeah. Right. If you Google it, yeah.
Hey, who are we playing today?
We're playing Need to Breathe. And the
I've
song,
heard of them.
Yeah, the song is called Who Am I? They're going to be playing at Lexington Rupp Arena October 17th. So that is that today?
That is today.
That is today. You can go check them out today.
Need to breathe. Who am I? And Rupp Arena.
Yeah, they're going to be playing with Judah the Lion.
Okay.
And so they're all going to be there tonight.
When Judah the Lion, they were here, right?
No, that was Chasing Judah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, big difference.
Yeah, okay. So here it is, Need to Breathe. Are they a Christian band?
They're positive, I think.
All
right. Yeah.
Here it is. White lies and desperation, hard times and conversations. No one should ever love me like you do. Sometimes my bad decisions define my false suspicions, and no one should ever love me like you do. While I'm on this road, you take my hand somehow. You really love. There it is, Need to Breathe. Rupp Arena tonight. Dusty, we got 30 seconds till bottom hour news. Anything else to leave us with? I'm sure you got some shows.
Yeah, let's see. You got the Wood Brothers are going to be playing at Old Foresters Paris Town Hall.
Right.
They're going to be playing October 19th, if you want to check that out.
Thursday.
Let's see. Jim Gaffigan is coming. He's going to have a few dates in October.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to be at the Louisville Palace on the 20th.
Okay.
And, the 20th, and he has 2 shows on the 21st. So plenty of time that. And the 20th, you also got Cole Chaney at the Burl. Everett, which we previewed before, they're from Western Kentucky.
Yeah.
Your buddies.
Mm-hmm.
They are going to be Festafil in Louisville. And then there's the Festival of Friends, October 21st through the, which is at the Portal at 15. And it's the Monarch in Louisville. That's part of it. Okay. That's the 26th. Anyway. So, yeah. Some stuff coming up.
Cool.
Check that out. Need to Breathe is an awesome band. I got to see them at Forecastle. It was one of those, like, kind of in the later afternoon bands, right?
Yeah.
And, like, I was super impressed. Like, they were, like, it was one of those, like, I didn't expect anything from it. I was just like, oh, like, this would be nice to
watch.
You
came in with low expectations.
And it blew me out of the water. Like, they were a fantastic
band. So did you become a fan of them after that?
Yeah, absolutely. I started following them after that. And that's why it popped up on my radar. Yeah. Because they're going to be at Rupp Arena. So that should be a good show. I bet you can still find tickets tonight. Judah the Lion is also a great band because I got to see them as well. Mm-hmm. But should be a good time.
There you go. Dusty with the Kentucky Music Preview. Dusty, appreciate you being on this
morning. Thank you, Joe. No
problem. And Stiff Funeral Home is coming on here next Tuesdays with Stiff.
Are you going to get them to vote?
No. No, only official guest on the show vote.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. So, none of these students.
And you can be official just by calling in. I mean, it's like, if you really feel one way about a candy or the other, you can call in and let me know.
If you want to stand up for Musketeers, then you're wrong.
I mean, they're getting blown out of the water.
You're wrong.
It's over. Yeah. It's 5-0, unless we have like six callers call in in the next 30 minutes to vote for Three Musketeers, which would seem like a lot of effort to make sure Candy Bar moves on in a bracket that we're
you
doing.
You are texting
matter.
All your friends at that
yeah,
point.
Yeah, you gotta call, get your friends, the neighborhood together to rally behind Three Musketeers. On the corner of 4th Street and Main in front of the courthouse, we love Three Musketeers signs.
The signs, the honk, call.
Joe's wrong, Musketeers right, stuff like that.
I want to see that sign.
Yeah. 9:32 in the morning. All right, Dusty, appreciate it.
Thank you, Joe.
Yeah, Tuesdays with Stith coming on here next. Either Ann Yeager or Mary Stith Hamlin will join us here on The Joe Show. It's 9:32.
Resetting your password. Unsubscribing from emails. Printing anything. Why are simple things sometimes so complicated? Thankfully, with an auto owner's insurance independent agent, getting the right coverage for your business doesn't have to be one of them, so you can get back to more important things, like learning how that printer works. That's simple human sense.
Ask Dexter and Reitmeier Insurance Agency in Danville if auto owners make sense for you. Call me, Mark Dexter, or Chris Reitmeier at 236-6686.
Hi, this is Jenny at the Danville Nutrition Center. Get ready for the great outdoors with our Rootology sinus and allergy support products. Or try our DEET-free, all-natural bug repellents that are safe for the whole family. We even have a natural bug repellent for dogs, which is specially formulated to repel mosquitoes, flies, fleas, and ticks. Enjoy the great outdoors naturally by visiting your locally owned Danville Nutrition Center. We are located at 802 South 4th Street in Danville.
Now available at Farmers National Bank, free checking and a free gift. Simply open a new Farmers National Bank personal or business checking account and receive a free gift. Minimum required deposit is only $50. We make the process fast and easy. Call 866-888-0220 or stop into one of our 12 convenient locations. Farmers National Bank, with locations in Danville, Bergen, Harrodsburg, Junction City, Lancaster, Perryville, Stanford, Liberty, and Middleburg. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Oh, it is so true. A nasty car don't run good. You want to make sure you get your car running great by looking great. Go to Thoroughbred Car Wash off Perryville Road, Danville. Your car will love you for it. Nothing better than a clean car from Thoroughbred Car Wash, Danville.
At the car wash. Working at the car wash, yeah.
That's Thoroughbred Car Wash in the Big Lot Shopping Center.
Almost every small Kentucky town has a go-to restaurant. In Central Kentucky, it's the Bread of Life Cafe in Liberty. If you like a good buffet, you'll love the huge down-home cooking featuring three fully stocked buffet tables, or you can order off their extensive menu. You'll find something delicious for every person in the family at the Bread of Life Cafe. Visit the gift and sweet shop at the Bread of Life Cafe, 5 miles south of Liberty on Highway 127. Open till 8, Monday through Thursday, 9, Friday and Saturday. Feed your tummy and your soul with a stop at the Bread of Life Cafe and Buffet, 5 miles south of Liberty.
Hi, this is Jenny at the Danville Nutrition Center. Get ready for the great outdoors with our Rootology sinus and allergy support products. Or try our DEET-free, all-natural bug repellents that are safe for the whole family. We even have a natural bug repellent for dogs, which is specially formulated to repel mosquitoes, flies, fleas, and ticks. Enjoy the great outdoors naturally by visiting your locally owned Danville Nutrition Center. We are located at 802 South 4th Street in Danville.
My name is Casey Riggs. I'm from Rough River, Kentucky. I've sung all my life, started out in church, of course. From there, I sung any opportunity I could. I come to Studio G to develop my voice and, most importantly, confidence. I'm now part of a group called the Purple Vibes. We sing in local festivals, shows here at Studio G, and without Studio G, I wouldn't have that opportunity.
Studio G is the performing arts place. To learn more, call 859-734-4394. Studio G, the G stands for growth.
Hi, former CIA officer and survival expert Jason Hansen here. I teach people how to prepare for the unexpected. And right now, most Americans with a 401k, IRA, or other types of retirement accounts are not prepared for a financial crisis that could hit the U.S. in the next 45 days if we don't fix our ramped up government spending. I have partnered with Advantage Gold, the number one rated precious metals company in America, to release my new financial crisis survival kit that's 100% free for everyone with a retirement account who calls in today. Simply call 800-900-8000. My financial crisis survival kit is jam-packed with valuable information on how you can protect yourself with physical gold and silver. Your first step to protection is calling 800-900-8000 and speaking to one of their gold IRA specialists.
Advantage Gold is not an investment advisor or a tax advisor. Check with your financial advisor before investing.
Again, simply call 800-900-8000.
This Joe Show Weather Report brought to you by...
It's brought to you by our friends over at... Cattleman's Roadhouse. Treat yourself to a delicious meal at Cattleman's, where their steaks are aged 28 days. Hand cut, second to none in tenderness and in flavor. Cattleman's Roadhouse, Danville Bypass. A great steak truly is just the beginning. All right, you get cloudy skies today. A high of 58, a low tonight 39. You get sunshine expected tomorrow. 70 degrees is the high. And on Thursday, rain showers likely, mostly cloudy. And a high Thursday of 67. Right now it's 9:37 in the morning. And it's Tuesdays with Stiff.
The following is a paid program.
Thank you for that. Jim Parman made it official. We have Sarah and Ann Yeager in studio.
Good morning.
We don't usually have a tag team when it comes to Tuesdays with Stiff, but Ann Yeager and Yeager needed some help this morning.
I can talk.
Y'all have to bear with me. My throat is still a little weak from having my tonsillectomy.
Yeah, you have
I sound kind of crazy.
You could host like a late night jazz show.
For some reason, you didn't bounce back like my five-year-old.
No, at 47, it's a little bit harder.
It's harder for people that are older, right? Tonsil removal surgery.
Yes.
Tonsillectomy. My five-year-old had hers out the week before Ann Yeager did.
And she's back.
Oh, she's fine.
All the way back.
She was singing.
She is so back. 2 days and it's been how long for you, Ann Yeager?
Not quite 2 weeks.
What are you able to eat? I mean, can you still eat normal stuff, or?
Yeah, you just have to chew it up really well.
All right.
And be careful. No toast.
Toast is a no?
No chips.
No toast, no chips?
No. Which, it doesn't really matter. I don't really eat chips that often anyway. So.
Yeah, it's not like you're sitting around eating chips.
Sherbet is my favorite thing right now.
Sherbet?
Sherbet.
Yeah. So there you go.
I turned into my grandmother eating sherbet.
So Ann Yeager and Sarah in here this morning talking about Stiff Funeral Home. So Sarah's... See, this is kind of biblical. Sarah's kind of the Aaron to Moses, who's Ann Yeager, right? Because Moses had a stuttering problem, so he brought along Aaron, correct, to do the speaking for the Israelites.
Oh, okay.
Isn't that correct? And so Ann Yeager,
you're the preacher's kid.
Well, I was hoping you all would back me up on that. So no, Ann Yeager doctors. Is kind of the Moses here, and Sarah's the Aaron, so she's the mouthpiece for Ann Yeager.
But Sarah's going to talk today because we're going to talk about insurance. Mm-hmm. And Sarah is the one who files the insurance at the funeral home. So when people have a claim, when we're helping families file death claims, she's the one who does it.
Okay.
And so she's going to talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly of that because people think it.
So there's all kinds of different insurance, and there's lots of different insurance companies. I have filed insurance with pretty much every insurance company out there. Transamerica is probably the one that everyone knows. It's the big one. There used to be an office here in town. There's no longer an office here in town.
I remember seeing that. Where was that?
It was on 4th Street or out Houstonville Road.
And they, and they bought Commonwealth and Monumental.
Right. So so if you have a Commonwealth of Kentucky policy, it is now a Transamerica policy. If you have a Monumental policy, it is now a Transamerica policy.
All right. So everything is now, those are
it's
Transamerica.
It's all Transamerica. All right. It all has to go through Transamerica. And when you want to do something with that policy, you have to go through Transamerica to do it. And they will send you a packet of paperwork, which is huge and overwhelming. And I can help you go through that and see what you have to fill out and what you don't. Because there might be 6 pages, but you really only have to fill in like 4 spots.
Okay.
But it makes it very, very confusing.
It's overwhelming, especially when you've had a
death. It is very overwhelming. And they ask a lot of questions that are not really, you don't have to actually answer them. You just have to go through. And it's very wordy and verbose, and you have to read through it and figure out what you actually have to answer and what you don't.
Yeah.
And there's lots of legal ease.
And I'm pretty good at figuring out, like, nope, don't have to do that, don't have to do that. You can just put that aside. Don't have to do that.
Okay. And this is for death insurance.
Yes, for life claims.
For life claims. When we file someone's life insurance, when we help families, it's one of the things we help families with.
I've told Rebecca before that one of my biggest fears is, of course, I would in this situation would be dead, but that I would die and that she would forget that we have life insurance. And like no one would tell her. And the insurance company, I don't know if they're obligated to say anything. I'm just like, she'll just in an array of grief will forget about it.
Some of them will eventually call and say, hey, we're looking for the beneficiary of this policy. We found that you all did the services. Can you help us find them? That happens every now and then. It doesn't happen very often, but it does happen every now and then. And now a lot of people think it's a scam when it happens. So people are like,
well, you get so many scam calls now. I mean, like we just got one moments ago before you all walked in, another scam call, right? So people think nowadays they're on high alert thinking everything's a scam.
And there are scams relating to it. So you have to be very careful with that because you don't want to give out information, especially about someone, a living person's information, their social security number, because that's what they'll ask for. They'll ask for your name, your address, or your social security number. That's what they need for a beneficiary. So you don't want to give that information out to just anybody, obviously, because that's just ripe for, you know, identity theft. But there are some companies that will go looking for people. Sometimes the money will get turned over to the Kentucky state into the, was it the treasury? And it's unclaimed money, I think you go to. But that rarely happens. So, but there are ways that you can do a national search for life insurance. You can send out, I just did it for someone else. You put in their information. If you're the beneficiary, put in all of your information, and it will basically do a national search and see if you are the beneficiary of a life insurance policy out there.
What would happen if someone dies that had a life insurance policy and their beneficiary has already died as well?
That's when it gets more complicated. We have to get their death certificate and whoever basically is the next in line. And then you have to do, a lot of times you have to do a survivorship or an heirship form. And so, like, if your parents were the ones that had, say, a husband and wife had life insurance, and the husband had the wife as the beneficiary, well, then the wife died, and then the husband died, so then their children would be the beneficiaries. Okay. But they have to fill out the heirship policy, the heirship things. They don't always. It's dependent on the life insurance company. They're each different. They will each require different things.
Okay.
Some require more, some require less, and since COVID, it has changed. Some of them will do it all over the phone. Some of them will ask me for 15 different forms and a death certificate that it has to be mailed in. So you have to go through all of it. I have to talk to the companies. I make a lot of phone calls, and I spend a lot of time on the phone with them, and I keep calling them until I get something done.
Yeah, yeah. So, boy, I had a question, and it just left me.
Sorry.
And it was about... It was along this topic. Oh, we've talked before with Ann Yeager about the stories of, first of all, making sure you check your policy and who the beneficiary is, because there are stories of divorce, husband dies, ex-wife is still left on that.
Change your beneficiary.
Unless, of course, you want to leave it to your ex-wife or whatever it may be, but how important it is, because there are stories of that happening, right? You all have dealt with that before?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And what can you do about it?
Nothing.
I mean, it's on the policy?
Done, yeah.
The beneficiary is who that is?
After someone dies, you cannot change a beneficiary. So if...
Before they die.
Before they die, we have to do all that paperwork.
Right. Okay. After someone has died, if you did not change the beneficiary, that's going to their ex whatever, if that's who the beneficiary was.
But that, yeah,
there's
that,
no rule they have to use it to pay for the services.
No.
And they can do whatever they want to with it.
Right. The beneficiary gets that money and they can do whatever they want. Doesn't matter.
They don't have to pay for a funeral.
Nope.
They don't have to give it to a spouse or...
Nope, they can go buy a new boat if that's what they
want. Yeah,
so
imagine in this situation, let's just $100,000 policy. Ex-wife, husband go through a divorce. It can be kind of nasty. We know divorces can. The ex-wife, husband dies, ex-wife gets $100,000 and she says, forget this guy. We went through a nasty divorce. I don't want to give him any of this money. I don't even want to pay for his funeral.
Right.
So the family's left to pay for the funeral costs, and the ex-wife, who hasn't talked to her husband, ex-husband in 15 years and can't stand his guts, gets a brand new boat or house out of it or whatever it may be.
That's exactly
so you
got to
make sure you have that taken care of in that situation.
Check your policies, check your beneficiaries, make the changes before something happens.
There you go. We're with Sarah and Ann Yeager here in studio. It's 9:45 in the morning, Tuesdays with Stiff here on The Joe Show. We'll step aside. We'll come back and finish up the conversation with Stiff Funeral Home, my mom's favorite segment of The Joe Show. She likes it more than anything. She likes hearing you all talk more than me. She likes hearing about Stiff Funeral Home, and we got the second half coming up next.
Hey, Joe, did you know Big Deals has got something new?
Where can I save money now, Radio Rick?
We've got the Anderson Lifestyle Boutique in Danville. Buy a $50 gift certificate for a Big Deals price of just $35.
Sounds awesome. What do they have?
They offer jewelry, apparel, gifts, and home decor. They do embroidery and monogramming. Come and see their selection of comfortable jeans, heavy canvas bags, lamps, art, scratch-made soap scents, natural soy candles. Find the perfect curtains, blinds, and shutters for your home.
Sounds great. I know where I can get my wife a gift and save money. Please don't tell her.
Joe, you like to eat, don't you?
You bet.
Save money at the Big City Pizza Company in Danville. Another new way to save.
I'd love to have some of their three cheese mac and cheese pizza.
Well, get over to hometownlive.net and save on Big City Pizza with a $10 gift certificate for just $7.
I'm on it. Pizza night tonight at the Memphis House.
You, too, can save with more big deals at hometownlive.net. Lots of discounts like Bread of Life, Sweets by Cindy, O'Charlie's, Applebee's, the old bus station, and A&L Accessories.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cartown Kia.
It's your choice. The new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cartown Kia and CartownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 to its sign, 2023 Kia Sorento, 2556 to its sign, go $349 down, $349 per month. 36-month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, dock, and acquisition fees with approved credit. No security deposit required. All incentives to deal with price may not include dealer added options. See dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st, 2023.
Royal County's our home, so let's keep it clean.
Be a better recycler. Learn what you can take to the Boyle County Convenience Centers and Recycling Center. Download the new free app, Boyle County Recycling, for Apple and Android phones. The app features the Waste Wizard, where you can search any item and what to do with it. Also, play the sorting game. Download the app and be a better recycler for Boyle County.
Boyle County's our home, so let's keep it clean.
If you're feeling hopeless, alone, and broken, maybe empty inside, Chloe's Petals for Home. Don't have all the answers, but we want you to know that it's gonna be alright. Chloe's Petals for Home. You are not alone, we're here for you every step of the way. Cause it's just around the corner, we'll find hope together. Chloe's Petals for Home.
For help, call the crisis hotline, 988.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Hey, good morning. You're heading to the airport, right?
Yep, thanks for checking. I like the car. How long have you been a rideshare driver?
About 3 years now, but I really enjoy it.
Isn't it hard to make money these days with the price of gas being so high?
Not for me. I use Upside, the free app that gives you cash back for every gallon of gas you buy.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you actually get real money back when you get gas with the Upside app?
Yep, I get real cash back every time I get gas.
Does that actually add up to anything?
I'll make around $200 to $300.
Wow, that's serious extra cash. I'm downloading the Upside app now.
Download the free Upside app now to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code TAXI for an extra 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank account, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code TAXI for a 25 cents a gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code TAXI.
Sutton Pharmacy, friendly service from people.
people you know. Generations of serving our community, immunizations, prescriptions, and so much more. Helpful people, free local delivery, mobile app refills right to your door. Visit SuttonRx.com. Sutton Pharmacy. Friendly service from people you know.
In Lancaster on Maple Avenue.
Last place feeling in life is no place to be. Ready for a new way of living? The Isaiah House will put you first. Long-term and short-term residential treatments, outpatient treatments, medication-assisted treatment, transitional living and job skills training. Isaiah House has the programs to the path of help, hope, and healing. End the hurting. Take the first step toward a happier, healthier you. Call the Isaiah House anytime, 24 hours a day.
This is your season to save on our incredible selection of new Kias from Cardtown Kia.
It's your choice, the new 2023 Kia Sportage or the new 2023 Kia Sorento. Just $349 down and $349 per month.
Unmatched design, performance, and savings all in one at Cardtown Kia and CardtownKiaUSA.com.
2023 Kia Sportage, 2318 due at signing, 2023 Kia Sorento, $25.56 due at signing, $349 down, $349 per month, 36 month lease, 10,000 miles per year, plus tax, title, license, stock, and acquisition fees with credit. No security deposit required, all incentives to deal with price, may not include dealer added options, see dealer for details. Offer expires October 31st, 2023.
Hey, Joe.
Yeah, Radio Rick.
Guess what? It's time for Lee's Famous Recipe Lunch in the Office again. Get up to 20 two-piece chicken dinners and tea. That's over $160 value. Absolutely free.
How does someone get these 20 two-piece chicken dinners, Rick?
They email us at radio@hometownlive.net. Or mail it 2063 Shakertown Road, Danville, 40422. Why they deserve free lunch in the office. We'll draw the winner on Wednesday. We deliver on Thursday.
Listen to us on your smart speaker. Just ask to play our call letters. WHIR.
In the morning, Tuesdays with Stiff, Ann Yeager, and Sarah Hamlin are in studio with us this morning talking about life insurance. Or also called death insurance.
Well, no, this is generally for traditional life insurance policies.
Okay.
Our insurance is different. So final expense or death insurance is different because those are companies that we work with. So they do pay out within a week or less, generally.
But traditional life insurance, like Transamerica, American General, those life insurance policies, those they have up to 90 days by law to pay out.
Yeah, so good point. And that's 90 days after everything is made official? Right.
That's after they get all of the paperwork that they require. But here's the problem is that sometimes they change what paperwork they require. Because I have one that I'm working with right now that I've made about 10 phone calls to them after sending in the initial paperwork. And about the seventh phone call, they told me they were going to require extra paperwork and sent the paperwork to us. So now I'm, doing that paperwork. And once that paperwork is turned in, then it's 90 days from once they get that paperwork.
Which
has been 2 months that I've been working on this so far.
Yeah, this can be troubling for loved ones who need the money to pay off bills or pay off whatever needs to be paid off with the life insurance.
Right, because the life insurance is not always just for funerals. Some people have, a lot of people have policies that are paying the funeral bill and then paying other things, like it may have been to pay off a mortgage or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So they're waiting for that money, and then when they're requiring all this extra paperwork, on top of all that, it's just sometimes it takes forever.
Yeah.
Our insurance is a little bit different. The final expense insurance that we use, and you're going to have to tell you more about that.
It's very nerve-wracking for families because they're already dealing with all of these other things and all of their emotions and grief. And now they're just trying to get things done and taken care of. And so when it's just jumping through more paperwork hoops over and over and over again, it's like this family that Sarah's working with, they just... Like the daughter-in-law's ready to pull her hair out because
they've already filled out paperwork and now they have to fill out more paperwork
and
they talking to different people every time or something? They don't.
Well, no, yeah. I've actually talked to the same guy a couple times and I kind of went off on him.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Why didn't you tell me this? And he was like, well, I don't know. Like they don't give you any good answers. I've asked for supervisors. I've gotten moved up, and
you think they're just trying to like push your buttons or you give up on it?
No, the longer they basically.
The way insurance companies work is your money where you pay a bill every month, that money goes into a big fund.
Right. And the longer that money sits there, it grows interest. That's how insurance companies are able to pay out these huge policies, because they're earning interest on this money.
It's how they make money.
And so the longer it sits there, the longer it earns interest. So the longer they hold on to this money and don't have to pay it out, the more interest it earns. So they want to hold on to your money longer, basically.
Yeah. Long.
And I don't, you know, they say that they want to pay it out within so many days. And some there are a couple of insurance companies that do pay out quicker. One of them named after a state. It pays out quicker than some of the others.
Okay.
Well, it does. But there are others that, I mean, I had to call the Department of Insurance on two of them last year because they were just taking so long.
Wow, that seemed, I don't know anything about this, but calling the Department of Insurance, is that like the...
That's like I'm telling on you.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Like you've messed up enough to where we got to do something about this.
We're filing claims against you.
Okay.
That's where they had every bit of the paperwork that they needed, and they still did nothing.
So what did the Department of Insurance do?
I mean, really, they just kind of slapped him on the wrist and did nothing. So,
but did you get your payment?
The family finally did.
Okay.
It was.
Yeah, and at that point, we were fighting for a family.
They needed the money to pay bills and to move on with their life.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah, we were fighting for them.
So if I bring you all in a copy of my life insurance policy, would you all like take a look at it?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll
make sure everything's okay.
It,
and this is when it ends. This is what you get if you die
we'll
or Rebecca dies or whatever.
We'll sit there. We'll call the insurance company. Make sure everything's in order with you.
Yeah.
Yeah, bring it
so that's
in.
The
I would
difference.
Love to go ahead and make sure everything's right.
All right.
Because we know all the questions to ask, because Sarah has to ask them after the fact. So if we can ask them ahead of time.
Yeah, especially the older insurance policies that we get older insurance policies in where people have been paying on them for a long time, and we realize that their face value is very little. And then they actually
That's their death benefit.
The death benefit is very little, like maybe $1,000 or something like that. But they've been paying on it for a long time. And it probably had a greater amount of cash value in the policy than it had before the person died. But that cash value was lost when the person died.
Mm.
And now all that's left is that $1,000 death benefit.
Yeah.
So
you can cash those out and get that cash and put it in something else.
We had this situation. I've told you all before, but I'll tell this one again. It's a really good example.
Okay.
We had a gentleman who came in to work with Lana to make his pre-arrangement. And he thought he had, now you got to follow these numbers, ready? Mm-hmm. $45,500 of life insurance. Okay. One was a $45,000 policy and the other was a $500 policy.
Right.
Okay.
$45,500.
So Lana calls. Brings it to Sarah. They both double check it. The $45,000 is a term policy that's expired.
Already over. Mm.
So that's a goose egg. The $500 policy, which his parents bought when he was a little kid, is now worth $6,638 and some change.
But if he had died, that he only would have gotten $500. That cash value would have been lost.
So
he cashed it out then.
We cashed it out immediately.
Right.
And put it in another fund.
And we put it in a final expense fund so it will continue to grow and earn interest. And he doesn't have to pay any more on it. Does that make sense?
It does, yeah. It makes a lot of sense.
So and his services, what he wanted, were paid for. But had he died and his daughters had walked in with those two policies,
oh my gosh, $45,500 and you get $500.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely wouldn't have covered his services, would have been a huge, so that's why we do the educational seminars, and that's why we encourage everybody to bring them in, because we're the ones, unfortunately, that have to look at you and tell you these things.
And that's awful. I hate telling people that, no, your insurance policy isn't any good.
Mm. Yeah, that's the worst.
That just seemed like the worst conversation to have at that time with someone who just dealt with the death.
Yes, it's the worst, and that's why, and so that's why we do these educational seminars, and that's why we talk about this on the radio, and... So if we seem pushy, that's why.
Because that makes sense. Yeah,
conversations are the worst.
Do it now.
Yeah.
While you're still here, right? That's why I was like, if I bring my name, can you take a look?
We might be able to fix it now.
Yeah.
But after the fact.
Too late after the fact.
Yes.
236-2113.
Yes.
Stitt Funeral Home, 236-2113. Sarah and Ann Yeager, appreciate you all being on.
You all have a great day. Love on your people.
There you go. There's that sad music again. That means my time has come to an end of the Joe Show. Had a blast with you all on this Tuesday morning, and I hope we're at the start to your work day just a little bit more bearable. I'm Joe Mathis, signing off. I'm back with you tomorrow morning, dark and early, on Danville's one-stop shop for local news, local events, and local voices. That's the Joe Show, AM 1230, and the brand-new 103.9 FM. WHIR, Danville News Talk Sports. Until then, God bless. Have a great, fun, and safe Tuesday afternoon. Curtis McPeak's Home Sweet Home leads us home sweet home. Kentucky Sports Radio, coming up next.